very nearly viral. We have Roy.
We are right there, people.
Yeah.
And we have Lacey. Lace. And we're also joined by the very, very sexual Egal Matro.
Well, hello. Thank you for having me.
What? Do I not get a mention? Are you going to say my name at all?
Well, yes, I did. I said Roy and Lacey.
Oh, yeah. I think I cut you off.
Oh, just never cut it off, please.
No.
There's a use for that.
Mm. Well, so we're kind of drunk, and we just hit 5K subscribers.
Woo!
Yes. That's pretty good. I mean, I think Baron got us over the line by far, but, you know.
We seem to get along with all the bears on YouTube for some reason. Egal, hi.
How's it going, sweetie?
Hi. Yeah, have you ever done a live stream? Did you hear me?
It cuts out a little bit every now and then.
Yeah, it did cut out a little bit.
Say again now. Say again now. And
Chris, have you ever done a live stream on your channel before?
Once.
Oh, did you? Okay.
Last Friday. The idea was to live stream some gaming, but I couldn't get it to work, so we just ended up drawing shit in Photoshop and talking, a whole lot of bollocks.
Oh, really?
The best kind of night, that's how it should go.
Yeah, it turned out fun, so I'm glad to get the opportunity to stream again, especially with such sexual people as yourselves.
See, I'm annoyed because last night I streamed with Miss Anonymous, and I met all these wonderful people, but I'd almost been up for 24 hours by the time the stream all day, got in and started arguing. I'm so annoyed I missed it.
Well, that kind of sucks.
Yeah, it sucks more like, deep throat face fucking kind of sucks.
Isn't that the best kind, though?
This is not advertiser friendly. What are you doing? This poor fucking goddamn Australian is trying to make a quick buck by monetizing this stream, and you're ruining it for him.
Actually, yeah, I'm not. I'm not monetized, so feel free to say whatever the fuck you want. And Lacey, I would like to put my penis inside of you.
Well, I do have a lovely cunt.
Oh, man cunt.
Oh, God. This has gone off the rails really quickly.
Doesn't matter, darling. It's going to come back to it no matter how much you try and fight it.
Oh. I would like to come on your back.
I knew that was coming.
I'm setting the tone for the whole stream.
Egal got the opportunity to fuck me in the ass. It was Holly's idea, actually. I didn't want to do that.
Of course.
He forced that on us. I was like, I wanted to do a really sort of, down to earth, sort of normal, crazy approach.
He wanted to try and go for like a Schindler's List sort of scene.
What the
fuck? Oh, sure, sure. Pin it all on me, but I have the video proof on my channel of the behind the scenes where you say, oh yeah, by the way, you're going to fuck me in the ass later.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so you do. I forgot about that, actually. Oh, that's really funny. You captured the moment we told you about that sex scene. Like, I remember talking to you beforehand, and I was like, oh, would you be cool to do some crazy shit?
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, no problem. I told you wouldn't have a problem.
To make you wear diapers or something, I think I said. And you were like, yeah, cool. That's fine with
it. I was so surprised that you were just so willing to do such a scene. Most people were like, yeah, no, I'm not doing that.
Oh, he loves it.
Well, it's not like I'm homophobic or anything. I mean, it was just comedy.
Well, I thought you were a massive homophobe. I'm so surprised.
Oh, I know. I get all those sorts of things, but none of them are true, I swear.
That was like my gay attraction to you, your homophobicism.
Yeah, again, we are fairly drunk, so I apologize for that now.
Oh, no, don't apologize for a good joke, okay?
I don't know how good it'll be in the morning if I watch this thing back. It might be terrible.
Look, end of the day,
you're
going to be all self-conscious about it. Well, then, yeah, it's going to be shit.
Hey, look, you live one life, and you've just got to go for it. And if you make an idiot of yourself, fuck it, doesn't matter. Just wear it like a badge of pride.
Yeah, man, just balls deep.
Lacey knows.
Oh, right. Yeah, baby.
Oh, yeah.
So, okay, changing the subject a little bit here. Did you guys...
Oh, he's so uncomfortable.
He's a homophobe.
Listen, no, I'm not. I this is bullshit. I love the D. Stop making me out to be someone I'm not, Lacey.
But he
fuck.
Doesn't know how one smells or tastes.
Right. Just shut up. It's fine. I can imagine.
Don't you fucking tell me to shut up. For 2 seconds.
Trouble everyone. In paradise.
Lacey's drunk, everybody. Don't listen to a word he fucking says.
I'm the drunk, darling. I spent all the money and all the alcohol, all the cigarettes, and yet you forced me. You made me take my socks off, go into the cupboard, find all the microphone equipment, put them all over the microphone, and I'm the one who's bad?
Yeah, we... To be honest, we are talking to Lacey's socks right now. Which I know it's weird, but we've got no pop shield, so we've had to put both of his socks over the microphone.
In fairness, we did have one, but my friend stole it, so...
That sounds good. So, you know, hey, whatever works. Whatever works.
We don't sound as good as you, Miguel. You literally sound like the voice of Jesus.
It's sex on a stick.
Mm. Yeah.
Not sex on a stick, more like sex in the ocean. Yo just takes over the entire world. It's so wonderful.
What the fuck, man?
So poetic.
Oh, you just can't handle any homosexual content, can you?
It's
too difficult for you, isn't it?
Listen, I just hate gay people, okay?
Now, what it is, it's getting him too horny and he doesn't know how to control himself. His urges are coming to the surface, and it's just, it's overwhelming.
I won't lie, I am backing away from the boner I can see in his shorts. I am trying to move away a little bit.
That's a total lie. I am not wearing shorts.
They're camouflaged. Yes, they are.
Oh, Roy?
Yeah?
What are you wearing?
I'm wearing a festival t-shirt that I got at Sonosphere 2009 when Rammstein headlined. And I'm wearing some jeans and some Adidas Classics.
Well,
wrong answer.
No, he calls them jeans, but the thing is, they're more like a tent because they're all pent up to a very certain point.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty good.
I'm really surprised that you guys aren't naked right now.
I always stream naked. I thought everybody did.
Yeah. How do you know we aren't?
Yeah, well, Roy just described his attire.
It's called fancy, darling.
Did you see Matthew Robertson's little 5K video for us where he did it like nude?
Oh, that was
going to the bathroom, by the way.
Oh no, I didn't get a chance to see that.
Oh, he did like a little congratulations video, but he's like got no clothes on while he does it. But it's all from, you know, like, chest up, so it's fine. Oh,
those guys are friendly.
Yeah. Did you guys see the new video we did recently?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we got like fucking Chris Yost the E shit and stuff.
You were kind of cutting out there. All I heard was Chris opted shit.
Am I coming through clearly?
You are now.
Yeah,
it was like Chris Yossi and Michael Rowland and shit. They're all like having a little go, talking a bit of shit.
Uh-huh.
But it's like they don't address anything we say in the video, and it's just like, you know, it's all just like go fuck yourselves. Pretty much is what it translates as.
Yeah.
Oh, well, fuck, man. Roland's blocked me solely because I have bearing as, like, I follow him and he follows me. That's enough of a reason for him to block me. Like, he'll do that to anybody. Like, I know I tweeted something out, but he's that type of person. He's like, oh, you're a Buried fan, therefore I have to block you because you'll never say anything worthwhile. And it's, well, dude, for starters, I'm a peer. Yes, I am a fan of his content, but I'm also a peer. Not just, you know, I'm not some guy who just randomly comments on his videos all the time.
Yeah. Oh, sure. Yeah. Yeah, especially, I imagine, like, I know Chrissy Winters has seen that fucking video because she's liking a bunch of their tweets trying to defend her and stuff. And it's like, I imagine what the fuck her reaction was to something that bizarre. Like,
oh, I would not be surprised if she's like already trying to concoct how she can get it down, you know, whether it's going to be, oh, there's defamation or whatever, libel or, you know, some bullying or some bullshit, whatever she can whip out.
The thing is, it's so like, it's so fucked up. I think Michael Rowland or some shit was saying like, oh, just, yeah, you're misrepresenting Steve Chives. And I'm like,
I don't know. I think it was a fucking accurate portrayal.
Stupid.
Spot on.
It's so over-exaggerated. We're talking in like London East End accents, like Frank Spencer. I don't know if you know Frank Spencer. But it's so over the top and dumb. And I'm like, for you to say we misrepresented Steve Chives is an understatement. Like, it was like, that was the whole point. We just take it and exaggerate it to the nth degree and make it as fucking dumb as possible. And it's like, sure, there's an element of truth in there. Like, you know, it's exaggerated.
Wow. So you say you guys were trying to exaggerate it, but I'd have to go back and rewatch it because it's just like, wow, they're twins.
Yeah, I heard someone say it was like a documentary or something.
Yeah, it just looks shit, man. Like, especially with like Chrissy and her obsessiveness, like there's no other way to put it.
Yeah. Oh, sure. I mean, did you guys...
Robot.
Did we cut out?
Yeah. A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, just say can die.
Did you guys like it? Was it okay?
Oh, yeah, I laughed. I thought it was good.
Yeah, I was a bit worried that it'd be extremely annoying because we were just fucking insane in it for the most part. And
I thought we might have lost our channel over it, to be honest.
Yeah. I don't know about that. I mean, I was like, the characters are so fucking annoying, like the way you play Chrissy and Steve. Like, they're just so over the top and fucking dumb.
Oh, Steve.
Yeah, but you have to keep in mind, I mean, so are the people. You know what I mean?
Sure.
I mean, yeah, when we're trying to comedically portray somebody who is a piece of shit, then you're going to have a fuck of a time. And I don't mind saying that. I really don't, because I think both of them are quite despicable human beings.
Chris,
and I
man,
really don't know how the hell they sleep at night. I mean, I know how Steve sleeps at night with his wife's cock up his ass, but everybody else, I have no idea.
I reckon he probably sleeps more than that. It's probably like in a bomb shelter or something.
I don't know. I wonder if she has one of those little dog beds and that's where he sleeps.
At the end of the bed.
Or, no, next to the bed, not on it. He's not allowed on it. He's got to be, because he's a man, so he's got to be down on the floor.
Down on the floor.
Sure. And, you know, like the blanket that goes over him is, of course, anti-Nazi.
Oh, sure.
I love that pronunciation, anti-Nazi. I'm just thinking of someone's auntie being a total.
So, what do you say? Do you say anti?
Anti.
Anti, yeah.
Anti.
Okay, it's not that far.
Just a bit of the accent on it.
It's fucking Australian, mate.
I guess you're not, you know, was...
Lacey, where'd you go?
Come back.
Come back to us.
We miss you already.
We want you.
Say five...
Oh, goddamn English internet.
Get your fucking shit sorted, cunts.
To be fair, you know, he's got this ancient laptop and that through Wi-Fi is probably just like horrendous.
Okay, they're back. Good.
Yay.
And they're back.
Oh, do we keep cutting out?
You do. Yes, you do. We didn't hear any of that for like the last like 30 seconds or so.
Oh, thank God. I said something so dumb. I'm so proud that it wasn't heard.
Oh, seriously? This is why I got you on my stream. It's like I wanted that shit that you say when you're drunk and that you're probably going to regret in the morning.
There's hours of that ahead. Don't worry about that.
Well, I don't know. We'll see.
Oh, I have all night.
Hey, you can leave.
Good at having conversations when they're drunk. It's quite interesting. We had lots of lovely conversations, and I mean, I was sober, so I could actually gauge that they were good conversations.
Sure, I mean, a gal, while you were with us, I'm pretty sure we were drunk, like, the entire time. I don't think you saw us sober once.
I didn't? Well, I don't know. Did you wake up drunk? Because I could have sworn in the early in the morning and early afternoon you were sober. You didn't really start getting drunk while filming until, like, partway in.
Oh, no, I'm just a good actor, sweetheart.
Do you remember when we were on the bus taking you back to the airport and fucking Lacey was asleep and drooling?
Yes. I was so tempted to take a photo of that, but I was like, no, I can't do that. That's too mean.
You didn't get
pictures? Thank you for not doing that.
I took lots of pictures, but I didn't want to do that because the poor guy got him up so late and then he got up so early just to see me off.
It was like prime fat material there.
Come on, be nice. Thank you, Miguel. I appreciate that a lot.
Oh, you're welcome.
I remember you saying I was pretty drunk on that first night when I was like crossing the road or some shit. I really don't remember that though.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Remember getting back to the taxi cab? Like, do you remember walking him back to the taxi cab?
Oh, I do. I
know how much he was swaying into the fucking street every time.
Yeah, kept walking in front of cars, and like it was like every like 3 minutes, he's like, "Look at me." He's like, "Did you get chicken and ribs?"
Good night, darling.
I don't remember any of this.
That's an indication of how drunk you were. If you don't remember any of it,
then you obviously had a good time.
Oh, he did.
And that's the important thing.
Yeah, did we play? We played pool, right?
I think that was the last night.
But a picture from.
Yeah, that was the last night. We did that.
T-Bitch, your channel seems to be primarily sort of songs.
It is so far. Just basically
you have a lovely voice, by the way.
Oh, well, thank you. I think yours is nicer.
Well, you know, it's fairly flamboyant.
Are you
I can be quite flamboyant at times too.
Are you planning on sort of you know, like building your channel, like, and making it into like a full-time thing, or are you just doing it for like a bit of a mess around?
At the moment I'm just doing it for a laugh. It all started I was doing some parody songs for a few friends, and I started uploading them on YouTube, and it's basically gone from there. I've done a couple of non-musical related videos, the tantalizing Tumblr time videos. I don't think I'll branch out into commentary videos.
They're pretty fucking good though.
I really like them. They're really good. And also, you just come across as a really nice person. That's like wonderful, you know.
Well, he comes across as a fucking pervert, to be honest.
Well, fine, but
if you look at his Twitter feed, yeah.
Fine, but there's a difference between a pervert and a rapist, and you're definitely just a pervert, so I can appreciate that at least.
I haven't raped anyone yet, but I noticed there's someone that's...
Oh, sure, you have that in the asterisk. That makes me feel real comfortable.
There's someone just joined the chat who I'd really like to rape, and that's Hackjob, so hello. But yeah, I'll stop being a rapist, and I'll just go back to back to being an ordinary garden variety pervert.
Yeah, I do apologize. We've not got the chat up. We can't see what's going on.
Yeah, I don't either.
apparently this is a gay stream.
Every time I do, for some reason now, it seems to fuck up my the stream I'm on, and it's annoying. I miss my computer.
Apparently I'm a gentleman pervert.
Oh.
Thank you, Mexican Hitler.
Does that mean you're the top kind. Of the monocle?
Does that mean
no, I'm a... yeah. It's the kind who will wear a shirt and a suit and a waistcoat. They'll buy you a drink and then spank you like there's no tomorrow.
He's the Mr. Peanut of perverts.
I gotta say hi to my my man lover Baz in all the way over in sunny Shropshire.
Hello. Hi.
Say hello to Baz. He's an awesome dude.
Shropshire. Hello, Shropshire. Baz. Shropshire, mate. Yeah.
He's a proper Shropshire him. That was too far.
Yeah, that's not how they speak in Shropshire. That's nothing.
Well, I don't know how they speak, so all I can imagine is, yeah, all right, Shropshire, I'm gonna be all right. How's it going, dude?
Okay. Well, he wants you to spank him, Lacey.
So, but stop, Shire. I know who likes to be spanked.
If you wanted to take a trip down to Shropshire and give him a good old spanking, that would be nice.
Trust me, the thing is, you call yourself a pervert. You're like vanilla, and compared to how I am, so
I think I am. Right. I'm rather bland and generic in my perversity.
What time is it right now in Australia?
Fuck knows. I'm not in Australia.
I thought you were in Australia.
No, I live in Norway.
You live in Norway?
They have an accent. You can usually tell from that.
No, I seem to remember you putting up a tweet saying you were in Australia.
No.
Stop fucking lying to me. I know you live in Australia.
Stop misrepresenting me. No, I live in Norway, and I've lived here for the past 11 years.
Where are you from initially, then?
Yeah, I'm from South Australia.
Oh, okay. I've confused some of that, yeah.
But if there's no way, that means he's really close to me, and I can have sex with the person.
Yes. And I'm planning on coming over to the UK sometime this summer. I'm hoping I can make it happen.
Oh really? Come hook up with us then.
No, hook up with me, not him.
Well,
you can hook up with him for a while, but you know.
I can share.
Oh, okay. That'd be cool. We're good. What month are you planning on doing this shit for?
Well, it depends. I mean, there's a meetup I'm going to in Denmark in September. So I'm not sure if I want to go to the UK before or after that.
Yeah.
But we'll see. Nothing is concrete yet.
But a girl, that he's being so racist to polar bears there. What the fuck?
The fuck?
I'm going for a quick toilet break. I'm going to leave you with Lacey. I'll be right back.
Oh, God.
How am I being racist to polar bears? What's going on here?
Because he mentioned how he wants to come to the UK, but doesn't mention how he wants to talk to the polar bears. Well, that's just rude.
Oh, okay. I thought you said I was being racist. I was like, what the fuck did I do?
I'd imagine he's gone back to Canada before I swing past. So,
yeah, more than likely. I'll be like, I got about 5 weeks left here, roughly.
You know, can I ask you both a very honest question? I want to know what the inspiration for your avatars were. If you'd be willing to tell, that is.
Yeah, that's fine with me. When I did, it's a combination of two things. Part of it is because I spent 2.5 years living in the Arctic, and it was polar bear territory, so there is some meaning for that for me, because I could have been killed by one anytime I went for a walk.
I love the way you animate that bear. It's amazing. Like I said, every time you say what, it makes me laugh so much. I don't know why that one thing cracks me up so much.
It's yeah, that leads me to the other half of it. It's a program called Face Rig. It's motion capture, so everything is my face. It's all my expressions. And the first video I did was 6 steps for getting over depression. And after watching it several times, I'd kind of decided that the polar bear at the end was very much me. And I'm like, you know what? I'm going to capitalize on this, and I'm just going to use the hell out of it before anybody else, you know, does.
Well, I definitely don't know anyone else who does. So, yeah,
Not really a whole lot of people who really use Face Rig for anything other than Twitch streaming.
I love it. I think it's wonderful.
It's unique. And it's highly sexual.
Like, I could rant about a gal for years, but I want to know why you're a turn.
Looks like a turnip.
Parsnip.
Parsnip. Why are you a
space parsnip?
I'll explain. Okay. I'm not sure if you know the author Terry Pratchett.
Yes.
In one of his first novels, he in the Discworld series, there was a constellation called the Celestial Parsnip, and I appropriated that. The avatar was made by a friend of mine from the UK,
right?
John Martin, right. Who's a Roy.
We have someone who has a really good sense of humor here.
What? That's no.
No.
Get it. The whole British humor that we were talking about before. That's where this comes from. They completely get it.
Oh no, you would do. He's Australian. It's okay.
No, we're still a part of the Commonwealth, so.
You know. I love your picture. I I've been a big fan of Terry Pratchett. I always loved the Death Box. And so to see you transfigure that into your actual avatar, wonderful. Absolutely love it. Great points. Hats off to you.
Thank you, my lad.
Yeah, I'm back now. I'm sorry. Everything he said, I apologize for. I don't know what he said.
We don't care, Roy. We don't care. Lacey's speaking now.
Oh, this is bollocks. I'm sorry, Zach. This is fucking bullshit. I'm sick of this meme. No one gives a shit about Roy. I put on a brave face, and I'm, you know, because I'm a pretty sort of cool guy, and I don't show that it gets to me, but it's getting to me, everybody. So
are you so cool then, Roy?
Would you all just fucking quit it, please? Would you stop calling me a retard?
I'll give you.
Stop sending us requests to call you a retard, you retard.
Oh,
that's where that went there.
Who's that? I don't know. Answer it quick.
Hello?
Sorry, he's got to take a phone call right now. I don't know what he's doing.
Typical.
Yeah, I'm streaming with Jason
Norman. Oh, it's his brother.
Is that the one?
They would call you then, eh? Right. The other guys from 2 years in.
Yeah, yeah. He was on one of them, actually, his brother, but we didn't ever upload that fucking thing. I've got a whole one I'm supposed to upload, but I've been so busy with the main channel.
I thought he was in the baby one, his brother. And you did like the reverse clip in that of him, like putting the cape on and whatnot.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that was him. Yeah, that was him. Yeah, that's his brother. He plays a troll, but like...
And he was in the one where he gets killed.
Yeah.
That was uploaded.
Oh, yeah. No, but not to the side channel, not to 2Biz In. Like.
Oh, no, I just meant like, out of all the people that he could be calling, I kind of was placing the best between those ones, but I kind of figured the other guys would be calling you, because doesn't he usually? I don't know. That's just how it was when I was there.
Yeah. I mean, it's funny because like, a couple of, I don't know how long ago it was now, I'm guessing about 4 or 5 months ago, we were only on like, 53 subscribers or something. That's okay, man. Don't worry. I'll keep it going. My leg has gone so dead. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Sorry.
This is what happens. I try and stand up, and my legs go so dead from the beatings Royce give me verbally and mentally and physically.
I apologize. Yeah. What the fuck was I talking about? He's just distracting me to fuck the prick. Oh, yeah.
When your channel only had 53 subscribers or
something. We only had like 53 subscribers, right? So, and then we jumped up to about 3,000 really quickly. And then because of Bearing and stuff. And then like it seemed like no one gave a shit about the older episodes. Like they didn't really go back and watch them. It was just the new episodes we kept doing. So with Liam's brother, he kind of stopped being in it, and we always wanted to like to bring him back in because we found it pretty funny. I mean, but no one went back and watched that shit, so they wouldn't have known what it was about. So we had to get like a bit of backstory in there almost to bring him back.
I did go and watch some or most of the back videos. Like I usually do that when I find somebody I like. And back then, I think I did watch most of them. I guess why I know those.
For example, I'm guessing you both found us from that Bearing video. Did you both find us from that video?
Yeah. And then I immediately started watching all the other stuff that you had.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
okay. So a lot of people don't. I mean...
No, I know what you mean. Like, tons of people do not backtrack. Like, I can look at some of my older videos that are better, but they've got, like, 20, 50 views, and it's just like, fuck.
Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, like, the new videos do fucking really well. The one we've just uploaded is already over 2K, and we just uploaded it today. But, like, a lot of the older videos are, like, struggling to get, like, to that 3K mark. And they've been there for, like, over a year at this point. I think we've just passed the year mark, so...
Yeah, like, not a lot of people backtrack, and I don't quite get why. Maybe it's just not time, or they don't think of it?
I don't know. I mean, they don't have to. I don't give a shit as long as they're watching now. But, you know, it's like I personally, when I find a channel I like, I tend to go through their videos.
Well, yeah, me too. Absolutely.
Yeah. So we
never know what you're missing. And, you know, I like to see if, like, they're actually worth subscribing to because some people are just like one hit wonders.
That's exactly. You guys.
You blokes have quite a unique type of content. I think it, for me at least, it was quite sensual to go back and look through all your older videos. I actually wanted to, and because I found the content so intriguing and entertaining.
Okay, so I'm back now.
Oh, yes.
Good Lord, I'm so sorry for everything he said. He must have been filling you with so many horrible thoughts and so many lies.
Quite a few lies as well. I'd just like to give some love to the chat since they're gonna give me blowjobs later.
I haven't been in the chat. Hold on, let me open up a window.
Baz is saying, "I love Roy. His beard is beautiful. I'd root the cunt."
Oh, that's lovely.
Pork Meatball is saying, "Tell Troy to shut the hell up." And Hackjob is saying, "Roy, I love your manly beard."
Oh, can we get fucking Angry MGTOW in here at one point?
I want so. Why? I want so, so bad. I'm not a violent person, but for once, I'm ready to just go full knuckles at someone.
Oh, it's fine. We've got a video coming on him real soon. It's okay.
You know what the thing that pisses me off the most about him is, like, through the interactions I've had, he swears up and down that what he does is just a character and there's no truth to any of his content or videos and that he's just doing it for clicks. And then he goes and does something like that.
Well, like, I mean, the thing was...
Fuck? Like, you can't say that all your shit is characters and that you don't actually believe any of it if you're going to go through and try to pull the shit that he did claiming the reasons that, you know, it's because feminism and fucking shit. It's like, off, you little shit.
I mean, listen, so he did the two streams, right? He did the stream with Stuttering Soliloquy, and then he did SDA, right?
Yeah.
And it was like, when I watched the Stuttering Soliloquy stream, I'm like, okay, he's being an absolute cunt, from
absolute cunt is putting it like mildly, darling.
Sure. He was like a total cunt all the way through that. But I'm like, okay. So what he's done is he's got some person he considers to be like a nobody YouTuber, just a female that he can fucking ambush and look good in front of his sort of, you know, he's got an extremely cancerous fan base. I mean, his fans are fucking dickheads.
It's kind of
to watch his content. I mean, like some of the videos I've seen where it's just like, oh, this person, she went ahead to feminine and she could have AIDS. Why would you listen to someone who could have AIDS? Like, why would you want to sit with someone who could have AIDS?
Like, it's more like, it's like a girl, right? Like, I'm fucking angry, MGTOW. And like, I can't, all my fans, they fucking love me because none of us can get laid.
I mean, yeah. And it's like, so I'm like, okay, so I get what he did there. I'm like, right, what he did is he got her on and said, well, we'll have a nice little chat about feminism. And then he totally fucking ambushed her out of the blue.
And horrifically so as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It was just cunty as fuck, right? Mm-hmm. Don't get me wrong. But I'm like, okay, so I get why he's doing this at this point. I'm like, right, it's for controversy. It's to stir up a little bit of a storm, get some views on the go. That's fine.
Get attention sent your way.
Well, that's
I don't agree with it.
The last stream I was on with him, Ranting Feminist was on there, and he just, right from the fucking get-go, was trying to lay into her. And, like, I mean, the rest of us were, like, pretty much shooting him down, and it was I started going at him about his voice and, like, hey, you know, don't worry. One of these days, your balls will drop and your voice will change. And that was the point he rage quit.
That was the fucking stream on our channel.
Oh, was it?
When my mic cut out and I couldn't say fuck all.
Okay. And it was one of them.
Yeah. Like, the thing is, I always kind of liked him a little bit. I was like, he's just like, you know, full of shit and it's fine. He's actually an all right guy.
Like, he always came across as like a fairly decent person, but just somewhat confused.
Yeah. I was like, I don't give a shit what he believes in personally, and that's fine. If he honestly is like this sort of woman hating dude, I'm like, well, you can do that because that doesn't affect anyone. As long as you're sort of sat in your own little corner preaching it to morons, that's fine.
Do that all you bought the whole it's just a character thing. I really didn't, because he never dropped it, you know?
I did, because like I've talked to him like off air and shit a couple of times. Me and Adindro did a couple streams with him, and we had a lot of downtime in between the streams, and he was like quite sort of nice and sincere. So I'm like, okay. So when I saw the stuttering soliloquy stuff, I was like, all right. I mean, he has just fucking sort of thrown her under the bus just to further his own bullshit.
You've gone from general a nice conversation to literally trying to like fucking attack somebody.
Yeah, but you also have to keep in mind that he was having a private conversation with like two guys. His attitude seems to change when there's women around. That's where all the resentment is.
But I know he was trying to sort of pick up his channel growth. I know for a fact he was.
The thing that makes me know that he is like full of shit when he says it's just a character is because of Markov O'Connor, which referred to as Muffin, because he referred to Angry as one of the monks and as like a hierarchy in the group. And it was when Angry MGTOW actually started interacting with our community more that he lost that title.
Yeah, I mean,
that makes me wonder, like, if he was that deep in the community and that deep in the philosophy that people were like looking up to him, like, was it just a character, or does he believe the shit that he spouts?
This is the person, right? Like, because I started watching the stream between him and
Stuttering Soliloquy,
that's the one, and his voice was annoying me halfway through. And the first thing I heard after skipping, after the video loaded, was, how many guys have you let fuck you?
Yeah.
Like, I'm kind of speechless at that. Like, that you're trying to make, like, you're trying to make a point, you're trying to sound like how bad feminism is, but you just turn around and go, how many dicks have you had inside you?
Oh,
and that, it just—it disgusted me.
And he wouldn't even answer when it was Baring and someone else. I can't remember, but they were trying to ask him what kind of porn he masturbates to, and he wouldn't answer because, well, if you're against women, what do you masturbate to? Because that is part of the philosophy of most MGTOW is that, you know, forget women, just jerk off the porn.
From the way Twitch's go bingo, and apparently it's just masturbation to me. So,
That's true. That's fair.
I mean, who would?
I mean, the thing was, and it's like, okay, so he had that fucking stream of her and shit, and I'm thinking, okay, so I mean, he's had a, you know, before that he had a lot of interaction with, you know, I say this in quotation marks, but our community, right, our sort of little brand of YouTuber. He was getting down with that kind of stuff, and he was happy to like soften up a little bit around us, like, because when we
thing is, he was really sweet to us. He was no way in any way nasty to us when we streamed for him at all.
Oh, I was calling him straight out like gay and a faggot and everything, and he was just
really nice.
Yeah, he was just taking it in his stride and shit, and I'm like, okay, so
as soon as he's against the woman,
well, no, this is what I mean. So I'm thinking, okay. So what he's doing is he's just making a big song and dance. He's like, you know, I know for a fact he was trying to up his subscriber rate and stuff. And I'm like, he's come to the conclusion, like, right, let's stir up a little bit of fucking controversy. Let's get Angie on and I'll attack her, because fuck knows, I barely know who she is. She's probably some nobody, and I'm going to make her look like a fucking idiot in front of my cancerous fans, because that's what they demand of him. Right, so he's pandering to these fuckwits. And it's like, at that point, I'm like, right, well, that's very cunty, but I think I see what he's doing there. I'm like, fine, that is going to cause some shockwaves, and you are going to get attention. And then he attempted to do the same thing with, like, SDA, right, some dumb American. And I'm like, okay, fine. He's doing the same thing. And then Jeff Holiday jumps in halfway through the fucking stream and starts running him down and makes him look like a total fucking retard. Point where he's like, you know, he's like in DMs now, he's saying, oh, he's trying to dox him and he's talking about his kids and shit. At that point, I'm like, oh, right. You were just being a cunt before, but now you're,
it's like you get to a certain point, right, where you've got enough followers, enough people caring about your opinions. Do you have to make a choice? Do you want to be noticed and remembered because you actually have something worthwhile to say, or do you want to be remembered for being a piece of garbage?
Hey, if it was just purely a character and that's all he was ever doing, then he shouldn't be taken personally when someone, you know, it gets the best of you in a stream.
Exactly.
Well, I agree. Yeah.
That's why, like, I don't buy it. I really don't.
This is the thing. This is what he wanted. I assume that was the best thing that could have happened to him. Jeff Holiday jumping into his fucking stream. I'm like, oh, this is exactly what Angry MGTOW wanted. But evidently not, because now he's threatening to dox him and he's talking about his fucking kids and you know, going way too far.
That's like so far. You know, if you're talking about uploading someone, like someone's face picture, that's already quite a lot. But when you start bringing someone's children into the mix,
especially threatening getting them taken away. And it's like, for everything I know about them, they are good parents and they are good people.
Yeah, I mean, that's the point where I was like, okay, yeah, I'm pretty much done with him now. Like,
choose the other pet dog.
As soon as I saw that I was like, yeah, I'm done. Fuck him. And we are going to do a video on him. That's going to be our next video. You know,
because like MGTOW, if you're watching this, you know what, you were very generally pleasant towards us, but I just can't stand that kind of behavior. Like, it's not okay, you know? It's just not.
Yeah.
No, it's like, I don't know. See, like, I don't like the defense of it's just a joke, it's just satire, it's just a character. Like, there has to come a point when you stop and go, look, okay, I don't mean it. Like, you have to be honest. You have to be truthful. You can't fight to the death with the character. That's what really pisses me off. Like, at some point, you have to stop. Like, the same thing happened with Shelley Harridan with Suit Yourself, Sinatra and Myself, and there's a few other people. Because it was a Poe. We couldn't tell it was a Poe. But when we confronted him on Twitter, he fought tooth and nail to hold the satire, to hold the joke. And we didn't find it funny. And then it eventually got outed that, you know, like, was personal information because the dumbass had it posted all over the place. And Suit only put it out just to say, hey, look, is this you? Do you know that you have your information out there? And, like, eventually got to the point where he had to take down all his videos, and he made an apology video, and people got all pissed at us because we didn't get the joke, because we didn't find it funny. But I'm sorry, he had every opportunity to stop and go, no, guys, I'm just fucking kidding. You know?
Yeah,
it's just satire. But he fought tooth and nail to the end. Don't do that.
Oh, sure. I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. I'm not, you know, outraged easily. I'm not one of them people. I don't give a shit about anything for the most part at all. We sit down and we fucking make these videos and we laugh at this shit. We're never actually annoyed or pissed off at anything anyone ever says for the most part. I
pretty much get that when it comes to children. Like, as soon as you start going after kids, that's when my blood starts to boil, as you probably noticed.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it gets me very worked up.
Yeah, of course. But then, you know, if it was just the fucking Angie stream he did, like, I would have been like, okay, it was shitty of him. It was real shitty. But, you know, it was just a stream and they're just talking, and that's okay. Like, sure, he acted like a complete fucking cunt and he was trying to degrade her at every fucking turn. And I'm like, okay, well, you're allowed to do that. You're allowed to say what the fuck you want, character or not. You can do that, you know. Yeah. I wish a little bit she would have told him to go and fuck himself. I'm kind of screaming at this the fucking screen while I'm watching it.
I just can't stand how horrible he was, because it was just like an attack, but like completely unprovoked.
Sure, I mean, but that was his whole thing, right? He's like, I'm going to ambush this chick and it's going to be fucking hilarious. I'm going to create a big stir. And I'm like, that's fine.
Like, okay. You know, the thing is, in life, you're either just born a dick and everyone has to deal with you, or you can actively act like a dick and annoy everyone. And that's what, like, the road he's gone down.
Whenever somebody says something like that, I always think of the Team America speech of, you know, you're either a dick, an asshole, or a pussy.
Sure. But I mean, you know, controversy creates cash, right? It's
Yes, it does. That's one of the reasons I don't. Well, I mean, I know if I did drama-related content, my channel would be way bigger than it is. And I'm actually, you know what? I'm okay with that.
And I know for a fact, like, Angry MGTOW makes way more money than we do off our YouTube channel.
Well, yeah, because he pumps it out like crazy and it's like dribble.
Yeah, he makes a living out of it. We're not making a living out of our YouTube channel. He's making a living out of his. And so I'm like, okay, that's fine, you know, and you can do this shit. You can act like a total fucking cunt and, you know, try to create a stir and get attention and views. I was pretty convinced that's the only reason he did it. And I'm pretty sure he was playing his character. But I just didn't understand when Jeff Holliday jumps on his stream and makes him look like a clown. I don't understand why he jumped to doxing and talking about his kids. I was like, this is what you wanted. You wanted attention off people like Jeff Holliday, you know, and us and anyone else that was going to make videos on you after this. That's why you did it, right?
You know what exactly what it is? It is, I've actually had this encounter with Markov on several occasions. And what it is that they don't like men white knighting for women. They fucking hate it with a passion. It's okay for MGTOW to white knight for other MGTOW. That's acceptable because it's brothers in arms. But if a man white knights for a woman against a MGTOW, it's like the worst possible fucking offense you can do to them. And I don't get the logic. Like, why is it okay for you guys to white knight for each other, you know, brothers in arms, but we can't white knight for a woman? Oh, well, woman, you should defend a woman. They should be able to defend themselves. But yeah, but you defend other men. You don't see the irony in that? It's just people defending people It doesn't matter what their gender is.
Yeah, exactly. Sorry, I cut someone off then. Were you going to say something there, Chris?
Oh, I was just agreeing. Before we go on, Joys of Sorrow in the chat says, Roy and Lacey, I have copies of his stream with SDA and the vid after that. If you need them for your next vid, let him know.
Okay, no, I made sure to download the Angie stream and the SDA stream.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, hang on one sec, guys. What?
What are you talking about? All these things. Where's here?
Who?
So, Lacey.
Scroll.
Sorry, dude. We're just there. We go. Yeah. Yeah. So fuck him. He went way too far. He went way too far with it. You know, like we do shit, and don't get me wrong. I we want a bit of attention. Like when we
sometimes our actions might be like, you know, questionable, but there's always like a poignant reason for why we do them.
I mean, I think the worst thing I said in this last video was I called Steve Shies a power faggot, right?
People really like that one.
Sure. And do I want a reaction out of Steve Shive, Christy Winters, Chrisiosity, fucking Mike Rollins, all these fucks? Sure. Anything they do is a bonus, right? I'm like...
Because it's just going to help us out no matter what, really.
Yeah. I like the fact she's all annoyed and tweeting about it. Like, that's funny to me.
But, oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, it makes me laugh. I'm like, it means they've watched
the video. What makes me laugh is that like Christy Winter blocked me for literally, I have no idea why. Like, I cannot tell you. I've never tweeted at her. I don't think I've even liked a tweet that was directed at her. So, like, I don't even know how she found me.
She's just racist against polar bears.
No, anybody who's a bear, she's a species against all bears. Like, we all look alike, you know?
Yeah, I mean, well, I'm fine with Chrissy Winters, apparently, even after this, and I know she's seen the video.
Fine with Steve Shives, and that's impressive.
Yeah, I don't know why I'm now unblocked by Steve Shives. That's weird. That is fucking weird as fuck. But
oh, really?
Like, yeah.
I'm sure I'm still not, and I've tweeted at that fucker a bunch of times. Trying to get him to block me, and it's like, nope, won't do it.
Well, I was blocked by him. I was blocked a long time ago, when we first started the fucking channel, and for no reason I saw someone quote him in a tweet, and I could see his tweet, and I was a bit confused. I was like, okay, that doesn't usually happen. And then I just clicked on his fucking Twitter profile, and for no reason whatsoever, I've been unblocked by Steve Shives, and I can't work out why. But I noticed that at the same time fucking Chrissy Winters DM'd me. So, who knows? I don't have a fucking clue what's going on there.
Yeah, I don't fucking understand that shit. Like, that is an extremely childish thing to do.
Well, this was the whole point.
Childish, it's pathetic.
All the while acting she's smug going, and like, superior. I've got a degree, it makes me better than everybody. Like, you have to listen to what I say because I'm a sociology expert.
Yeah,
fucking cunt.
I mean, it's retarded. It's like she's arguing over Baron with Baron and stuff about the whole doxing thing. And then, like, one day I just wake up and I've got a DM from her, like. And it's not proof. It's not really proof of fucking anything because it's been addressed 100 times before. But she sent me a fucking
proof. She's
like a screenshot of Baron's video.
Yeah, that's pretty much it, basically.
But I'm like, why did you DM me? What was the point in that? Like, me personally,
because there's a tie between you and Baron, right? Like, you did a video on him, and then he hosted it on his channel, and she watches everything he does, so she's aware that you know him. Right? So
sure,
there's that
sure
association.
But, like, I mean, she could make a video on it, you know, or she could tweet this shit out. She's going to go and message people individually and be like, Baron's a cunt, you know?
Like a real personal attack.
That's kind of weird. I'm like, don't be going around it individually messaging people. It's like, We've done a ton of videos on people, and I don't go around individually messaging people saying, oh, this person's a fucking cunt. And it's like, it makes you look terrible and horribly petty. There's no other way around that.
She totally is. I mean, just the vendetta that she has against them for, like, I don't even know at this point. Like, you should have moved on a long time ago, but I think you guys hit the nail on the head. Like, I had the exact same suspicions that the only reason that entire group does it is to try to feed off of his viewers, because as we all know, not every one of your followers follows you because they like you. Like, I've noticed that heavily on Twitter, that a lot of people follow people they don't like, both on YouTube and on Twitter, just to see what they're doing. And that's where they get their audience from. So they'll make response videos, like all of them, though. That whole SJ crew will make videos about them.
Exactly.
And they'll pull in viewers from it.
I could somewhat respect her for just making videos and bearing if she wasn't trying to act like a white knight about it.
I mean, she's like, the thing is, she's like, Baron's a horrible bully, and I'm doing the world a favor by exposing this. She pretends it's something other than what it is. And what I think it is that when she does a video on Baron, she tends to get more views than her other videos.
Definitely.
I'm like, that's all it is. It's a way of just staying fucking relevant, because no one watches the fucking videos, you know.
Well, it's drama, right? Like, you're also going to get Baron fans who are just curious, because it'll pop up in their feed on the sidebar,
exactly.
And they'll be like, what the fuck is this? She's like, posted another one?
More like, what's going on this sitcom today? I'm so excited to see the next episode.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Exactly. Can't wait to see what Barry's going to say back to this one, and then he just doesn't do anything.
I mean, the thing is, I think we're pretty honest about it. I mean, who was it now? I think it was fucking Rollins or someone. He's like, oh, I like the way you put plus Steve Shives in your title. And it's like, oh, pandering or something he said. And it's like, well, of course I'm going to fucking put Steve Shives in the title, because I parodied him for like about 5 minutes of that video, first of all. Secondly, that's going to get us more views. Bearing Chrissy Winters plus Steve Shives, that gets us more views. And it's like, do you people not want your videos to get views? I mean, I'm completely honest about it. We'll put somewhat clickbaity titles out there, because I want people to watch the shit we've worked hard on. I don't want it to not get any fucking views. We want to keep growing. So I'm like, yeah, I'll clickbait it a little bit. I'll put in everything I can in that title to make people want to fucking watch.
When we clickbait, you'll actually get what we promised in the title, at least.
Yeah, I'm the same way. I don't mind if you have like a clickbaity title, but it better be 100% what you show it is. Like, I can't stand the fake bastards.
Oh, no, yeah, that's sure. I mean, when I say clickbaity, I mean more enticing, like, you know, more in terms of...
It is what it is. You create it so that people will click on it, and it's clickbait. You want people to click on it. There's nothing wrong with that.
Of course.
As long as you deliver.
Yeah, I mean, I think...
Which we usually do, so I think it's okay.
I think we were all right to put Steve Shives in that title, considering he's a major component of the video. Like, he's in it for a lot of the fucking time. So I think that's fine. I don't think that's pandering... And
don't listen to fucking Rollins, man. He'll try to nitpick the stupidest shit and still come out looking like a complete moron.
I mean, fuck that guy. I barely know who the fuck he is. I mean,
all I needed to do is see the one video with the pin and the hat, and I was like, nope, no, thank you.
Sure. I mean, and it's...
You're such a wonderful person because you put an anti-Nazi pin on your hat. Does that really make you so grand? Really?
Well, it means, Lacey, that he doesn't like Nazis.
Oh, no, it actually means he's more of a Buddhism, darling. Nonetheless, it was pretentious as fuck, and I hate
it. Yeah, it was.
I don't know.
More of a Buddhism?
I agree. I think we should all wear pins of things we don't like, because how else are you supposed to know that we don't like it?
I guess he's Buddhist, right?
Is he a Buddhist?
I believe he is, and that's the whole reason he wore the hat.
No, he's. I've never heard this in my life. I don't know if he is a Buddhist.
But that's why it makes it so funny that when he wears a Nazi symbol,
well, an anti-Nazi symbol, not a Nazi symbol,
which crosses out his religious beliefs.
I don't. What? Does that make sense? Is he a Buddhist?
Apparently.
I don't know.
I couldn't tell you. I don't watch his content. On one stream we did sit down and we watched his stuffed animal videos where he talks to his stuffed animals and he does like these little skits and they are just the fucking worst thing ever. Do you ever want to do a parody video?
Man, you know what?
That one on the mental breakdown of him and talking to his stuffies, his only friends.
Whether he's a Buddhist or not. Or he just doesn't like Nazis because, hey, why would you be against, you know, people murdering lots of people for no reason? It was still pretentious and it was still fucking horrific video.
Well, yeah, it was just moronic. It was cringy as fuck anyway. Like, I mean, and everyone's parodied that shit to fuck at this point, you know?
Oh, pretty much. The whole concept is fucking retarded, like, I hate using that word because it offends mentally handicapped people because they're more intelligent than he is.
He's acting like getting the pin on his hat is like being crowned the queen or something.
Well, he goes like out of his way to say that, you know, the people who disagree are all alt-right and therefore they're all Nazis and therefore they all should be punched. And like, it's the most asinine logic that I've ever seen. Ooh, yeah. And I've seen some shit on YouTube. Yeah. So, like, you know, I've seen flat earthers who have better logic than this guy. And that's saying something.
I mean, it's just like, you know, oh, well, look how much I hate the Nazis. Like, well, you've got to want somebody who come from that country time of year. At the same time, every child who's like 18 and just learned how to use a gun through propaganda thought they were helping the country. And so you going up and punch this person when they're 90 years old maybe isn't the rightest thing to do. But you're just like, oh, I'm so proud. I'm anti-Nazi. You haven't taken anything from all the families or all the lifestyles happen at war into consideration at all. For 2 seconds, have you?
It's just it's another buzzword to try to shut down people. It's just like, because they've overused patriarchy and misogyny and all those other asinine words.
It's kind of like, we've run out patriarchy, we've run out misogyny, we're close to running out races. Nazi, that's what we'll go for next.
Nazis. Yep.
Yeah.
Nazi, I mean, fascists. Yeah. Fucking bastard, guys. You're all fucking Nazi fascist, racist, misogynist, patriarchal dicks.
Yeah, I mean, the definition of Nazi is so broad. I'm probably a Nazi. You're probably a Nazi.
I think it's fucking hilarious when you're like, you guys are all alt-rights. It's like, you know that we're all on the left, right? We're just libertarian, not authoritarian.
Anymore. No, not anymore, because we're ruined by our own constructs, so therefore we don't understand who we are, so therefore we're all confining to everyone else's beliefs, but we don't understand why, basically.
We're all
incapable of thinking for ourselves and must be told what to think and where we are and our place in the world. Yeah.
I'm definitely like a left leaning dude. I don't know if other people are, but I find most people who are like anti SJWs or whatever or anti feminist kind of YouTubers, the variety is more.
Oh yeah, they're like all over the place, but you can't tell. Yeah. To be honest.
No,
like,
because it really
doesn't mean much. It's like, I think Irate Bear is as much right as I am to the left, or maybe just a little bit more, but like, you'd never know. It's like, he's bisexual, he's for all these rights. It's like, it doesn't actually mean anything. It's like, it's what your stance on certain things. So where your stance on like guns or abortion or like, those are more what determine which side you're on than the broader picture. And it's really narrow-minded thinking. That's why I don't mind being a centrist, because like both sides have good ideas and bad ideas.
Oh, sure. Yeah, I consider myself to be more in the center than anything. Probably slightly to the left at this point.
Well, I took that silly political test, and I am just lower left. I'm like, it's like two points to the left and down.
Oh, I took that fucking test. I was crazy to the left, actually. I was like way to the left when I did that. And I'm like, I don't think that's true. I don't think I'm that far left, but...
Well, where were you? Were you more authoritarian or libertarian?
Libertarian.
Well, see, that's not a bad thing. It's the South Park.
It's like... Yeah. Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. But I don't know.
Gandhi was, man.
Yeah. But yeah, I don't know. It kind of annoys me. It's like no one. It's like you're not allowed to joke about things, because if you do, it's, you know, you're kind of bullying people, or you're harassing them, or, you know, whatever it is. Like I get a bunch of like things back, and no one mentions like that it's jokes that goes over their head. It's like they don't care. It's like. It's like, fuck you, you're misrepresenting someone, or, you know, you're just being an evil piece of shit. And it's like, I don't think that's the case. I think our videos are quite light. Like, I think we don't really go that hard on anyone, to be honest. I mean...
Well, it's just common these days that people can't actually think for themselves, and they can't actually debate or hold a conversation. So the simplest way is to spout this rhetoric where you shut down the conversation, because, you know, there's no reason to talk to a racist or a Nazi or a fascist. Like, you just don't waste your time. They have to go educate themselves.
Sure. Like, yeah.
Fuck off.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I know what you mean. Yeah, it's funny, because I just imagine what they think if they, you know, when they look at our videos. I don't know what they fucking the reaction is, because they're so fucking weird. And I'm like, they must be like, what? What the fuck was that? Like,
I know.
I'm just trying to imagine Chrissy Winters looking at that last video we did, where fucking Liam's going around and just saying like, oh, Stave, and all this shit.
Oh, yeah, and I'm sure once you got to the do we just call that the science scene now? Is that where we refer to that from now on?
Yeah, well, it's advertiser friendly. We'll call it science, and it's fine.
Yeah,
the best
scene. Oh, yeah, I'm sure that probably had her like grasping her pearls, the most horrified look you've ever seen.
Sure. I was a bit nervous about that, because we reused the same joke from the episode you were in. I was like, oh, I kind of didn't want to do that, but it seems such a poignant thing to do with Steve Shives and Chrissy Winters.
It wasn't exactly the same joke. I mean, it served a purpose. You know, you weren't just pulling it out because he had nothing better to do. It had a purpose.
I mean, I know it was
an homage.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. We'll go with that, Chris. Yeah.
Well, you're going for the imagery, right? You know, Chrissy Winters giving it to Steve Shives, like it was good imagery. You know.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, that's what happened when they met up, right?
It was hard not to put that in there. It was like, what could Chrissy Winters and Steve Shives do together? And it was like, she definitely fuck him up the ass with a dildo or something. Like,
oh yeah.
Yeah. It was hard not to do that one, so I apologize if it was just a reuse of a joke, like a rehash. But we just kind of wanted to do it. It's our videos. Fuck you. We can do what we want.
Yeah, I have to admit, when people were posting like pictures and screenshots before I got to see it, and it was just kind of like, oh, they reused the same joke. But as soon as I saw that it was, you know, who it was based on, I was like, oh well, fuck, that makes sense. Quite appropriate.
Okay, I'm gonna go and grab a cigarette and light it. So I'm gonna leave you with the very drunk Lacey. But Egal, no, you're more drunk than me, definitely.
No way.
No, you are drunk than me, guys. Who's more drunk?
Lacey. I have to say, Lacey is. I've been with you guys both now, and yeah.
Mm. Yeah, fuck you. You're way more drunk than I am. But I'm going to leave you with him.
I can say it this way. To be or not to be. Dot
is the question. Come on, Roy, give it a chance.
Well, that's but that almost.
Let's see how sober you are when you try
that. Ever quick. That proves that you're more drunk than I am.
I think I've already won.
No, that's bullshit. That was a quick slip of the tongue. That doesn't matter.
Mm. Oh, that's how it always begins, right? Just a quick slip of the tongue.
Oh, yeah, Egal knows too well.
I do.
He knows.
You know what we're doing.
I'm gonna go grab a cigarette and a drink, and I'll be right back. But you talk to Lacey about how it was to do the video with us, Egal. Did you enjoy the aftermath and all that bullshit? Oh, he's chewing a chocolate bar, so he's not gonna be able to speak. But I'm gonna give him the mic anyway. Bye.
What a nap head.
But is essential to your cause.
Indeed. I feel like we've been leaving Chris entirely out of this.
I mean, I've been enjoying listening to you all rant. Unfortunately, I'm a little too polite to just barge into a conversation, so.
Oh, so you're a noob at streaming.
I'm a total noob.
How I was in the beginning, too. I got so used to just being quiet and waiting for an opening or someone to address me, and I hardly spoke. And then you kind of get used to that. You just kind of, you don't have to cut people off, but you gotta force yourself in there at some point.
No, I agree. Like, thing is with Creamy, sometimes people talk of you over and over and over, and you won't get a word in for 2 seconds if you don't just kind of man up and just speak, to be honest.
I have to be a man? You're assuming my gender?
Just, oh dear, hey, no, you can be a woman with giant balls. Just be like, fuck you, it's my time to speak now. Because if you don't, you'll never get to speak, ever. Trust me.
This is true. Especially
when you get more people in there.
Yeah,
exactly. Like sometimes you're in street. See, I just cut you off that quick.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
You know, like that.
I'm guilty.
That's what it's like.
You know what? I don't really give a shit because I like hearing you talk.
Fine, but if you've got something you really want to say, you know, you need to be more like, instead of just being like, you need to be like, no, okay, listen, my time. Listen to me right now.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's quite fine if you've got something interesting to say, but I'm afraid I have nothing.
I bet you're just worried to actually talk about it.
Well, quite possibly.
Yeah, come on.
I mean,
I'm back.
Oh, God, no.
No one cares.
Tonight, the whole MGTOW, angry MGTOW thing. I mean, I'm not terribly invested in that, to be quite honest. The whole thing with Christy and Baring is like, kind of done with that, to be quite honest.
How did the MGTOW thing make you actually feel?
MGTOW thing.
Yeah, because I mean, you're pretty. From what I gather, you're friends with Angie and stuff, right?
Well, not really friends, I guess. But I mean, I've been a subscriber and follower since she started, I guess.
You did a song for her, man.
Huh?
You did a song for her.
I did. Yes, I did. And to be totally honest, I haven't actually seen that stream yet.
Have you not? Okay,
I'm pretty sure no one ever wants to watch their last stream, so I think that's kind of like the code of the internet.
It is kind of hard to watch, to be honest. I just about got through it. Like, it was a little bit horrible to watch, you know. Huh. He's fucking. She like he makes her like apologize for all women and shit, and I'm like,
well, the thing is, like with you, Creamy.
Hmm.
Not being able to watch a video because you find it like so hard to sit through, and I am not finished talking, Creamy.
Wait, no, stop talking over him. You just said this a minute ago. Shut up.
No, I'm trying to make the point that you need to make sure you make people listen to you.
Shut up. Go on. Talk over him, Creamy.
Yeah, okay. No, that's exactly. I was just saying, I haven't seen the video because I haven't got around to it yet. Not because I am afraid to view it.
Yeah, you're involved with a bunch of YouTubers, right? Who do you watch? Who do you like?
Well, you're in like the big YouTube, big Twitter talks more than me and Roy are, so you're definitely involved.
I guess I am. No, I mean, I follow the usual suspects. To be quite honest,
film.
A lot of what is being said, and other people have said this, including R8 Bear, for example, a lot of the community have started regurgitating the same old, same old.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I kind of pick and choose which videos I watch nowadays. So, I mean, I don't really have a terrible amount of time to spend sitting on my ass watching YouTube videos. So
no, I completely understand.
If there's something that's a little outside the box, then I'll latch onto it. But I mean, that's why I love you guys. Because you do it in a little,
little snippets. That's
a little bit different.
I mean, I don't know, like, I get a bit worried about our videos sometimes. I mean, we really like them and shit, and we're like, we find the weird shit we do funny, but I'm like, I'm guessing it's like a proper love or hate channel, you know?
It's definitely love or hate.
Like, I'm guessing a lot of fucking other people are going to find that shit hard to get into. Like,
well, it's because they don't, I know the first time that I showed my friend here your video, she just had no idea what to make of it. She was just like, didn't laugh at all. She's just like, what the hell am I watching? To be fair, I started her on the 1,000-degree knife one because I thought that was hilarious. And she's just she didn't get it. She didn't get it at all. And I think now she likes your content. So it's just like,
oh, fuck.
It's really just a matter of like, getting to understand what your style actually is and what your humor is, because at first glance you're just like, what the fuck?
Widows that you can't figure out what the hell we're doing.
Yeah, are they serious? What the fuck is wrong with these guys?
I mean, that with that 1,000-degree knife video, we lost about 30 subscribers, I think. Mm-hmm. Just like straight off the bat, I remember uploading it and looking at our subscriber count and. Like instantly we'd gone down about 10. I was like, oh fuck, what did we do wrong? I was like, I didn't think it was.
I know what I did wrong, but I don't think there was anything wrong with the video.
I mean, the thing was with that was it wasn't like, you know, your typical sort of anti-SJW content. And
don't you find that funny that people be so fickle, you make a video that's kind of different and everyone just leaves?
I've heard of that. That's one of the reasons why I've kind of stuck to doing a variety, although my channel has veered from it over the last couple months because I don't have instruments. It's kind of hindered it. I had a good rotation. It was like I do a couple articles, then a song, then a comedy, then a couple articles, then a song, then a comedy, and then shit went down, and now it's just been kind of all like articles and stuff. And now that my subscriber count's gone up, it's like, oh shit, I might not be able to do the same variety.
Just fuck, tell everyone you're a better bear than Bearing and you'll be grand.
Oh god.
Mention Bearing.
No, I don't want to be a Bearing. I wouldn't mind having the subscriber base that he does, don't get me wrong, but I don't want to be, you know, I don't want to be a Bearing.
I mean, I do think to a certain degree you get stuck in a genre a little bit.
Try to do variety. If you start off doing a variety, people get used to it. Like I've had people all the while like complain, like if I do a music, they'll be like, I like your articles better. And then You'll have other people pipe up. You know, I really like your music. You should do more of that. And you can't please everybody, so you just got to do what you like. And I think that's what you guys do well. You know, if you laugh at your videos, then keep doing that.
Ah, thank you.
I mean, it's like, you know, at the point we upload that fucking 1,000-degree knife video and then we lose 30 subscribers, like, over the next couple of days, it's like, oh, fuck, maybe we shouldn't do that again.
No.
You know, it's like, well, what do these fuckers like? And it's like, you upload...
Riley Dennis. Just keep doing videos on Riley Dennis and talk about Bering and you're sorted.
Yeah, it's like you upload some typical anti-SJW video and everyone fucking loves it and you get like one dislike.
I know.
500 likes. And yeah, and it's like, oh, fuck. This is what we have to do forever now. We can't bury it anymore. We're stuck, man. And it's like, the thing is, we won't. It's like, we've gotten a little more involved in this shit ever since we got all our subscribers and stuff. Because
we've learned how many more morons there are out there.
I mean, before that, like, we were doing just random videos. If you look at our videos before the video that got uploaded by Baron, it was
more on subjects than it was people.
Yeah, I mean, it was mainly... Yeah,
like, it was more just down to these stupid things people find attractive on the internet, and for no real good reason. Like, there was no sexual intent behind it or anything like that. Just people love these videos for no reason, and so we tried to parody them. But then we became part of the SJW clique, and...
Sure, I mean, you know, it was like, yeah, it was just dumb things on the internet. And I guess that's similar to the kind of shit that maybe like H3 was doing and stuff like that. You know, just finding dumb things to take the piss out of. And like, we were always like a bit like anti-SJW and shit. Like, we
never agreed with it at all.
No, and we used to always watch a bunch of them kind of channels anyway.
Well, that's one of the reasons I don't do response videos is because, like, how many times can you watch somebody do a response to the same videos? You're basically watching the same video over and over and over, even if it is done differently. Like, I can only see Riley Dennis' videos so many freaking times, and when, like, you have, like, 20 different people you subscribe to all doing a response to it, it's like, not everybody's going to watch them.
No, it gets a bit much.
Oh, it does.
Especially if you don't come with a new angle.
Trust me, you'd be fucking surprised how many people want to watch these videos over and over again. It's a lot. They do want to watch that shit.
Oh yeah, I know. It's weird,
and that's evident.
Sorry, go ahead.
You know, it's evident from the fucking view counts that do a Riley Dennis video, or. You know, our idea was like, we'll cover Riley Dennis once because he's a big topic. And it was like, we'll do the Riley Dennis video.
She, darling. She.
She. Okay. Yeah, whatever.
It's not your channel. He.
whatever the fuck.
I call him he.
Okay, good.
Well, so do I. I mean, like, how are you a lesbian if you have a male body and have no dysphoria? Then you're just a male.
Yeah.
And just trying to get some that sweet, sweet pussy.
Man, people love that shit, and it's like we could probably make a whole fucking career out of doing fucking Milo Stewart and Riley Dennis videos, and it'd be fine.
Drink water.
You could pretty much pick anybody who is relatively big. Like, you could pretty much do nothing but Anision videos, and you would get quite the views, just because of how many people follow him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, the only reason we did a second Riley video was because the fucking the first one we did got taken down and it pissed us off, and we were like, well, fuck that, I'm not gonna just not do another one after that. We want another one up there. It was a bit annoying, and we wanted
to say just you, darling. It was both of us. It was rather angry.
Yeah, Lacey had no input in anything. Don't listen to anything he says. It was all me. But, and it was like, yeah. And it's like, just go fuck yourself. You can't just take our video down like that. And that was a really, like...
There wasn't even a comment or an argument made backwards towards us. Just fuck you, it's gone.
No, it, yeah. Riley is his huge, huge echo chamber mentality. Block everybody. Like, he even did a video on that where it's like, if you know, you don't have to respond to people. Like, you wouldn't respond to a flat earther, so you don't have to like respond to people who disagree with you because they're just obviously wrong.
Because, right, because the thing is, okay, like, I have a penis, right, but I have a vagina in my mind, so therefore, I'm just should be a girl, and you shouldn't see me as any other way, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And, as fuck, it's like that video got taken down. It did really well for us, that video.
We worked hard on it. Like, you know, thing is, we worked so hard on that video.
Do you still have a copy of that?
We do, thankfully, yes.
You'll have to send that to me. I'll see if I can, I'll change out the parts, and then it's pretty much untouchable.
Oh, thank you. Well, the thing is, though, you know, like, you sit there for like 6 hours straight watching Riley Dennis, and you put all this effort, and then people like Bering and yourself, and everyone comes around and helps you out, and then it's just gone.
Oh, I know.
That's gotta be disappointing. Yeah,
things that annoyed us was the fact that we got so many people for those appreciate you.
We didn't have to pay, and they were just out of goodwill.
You're out.
Again.
Yeah. Just by the way, Joys of Sorrow just mentioned in the chat that Angry MGTOW has just released a new video.
Oh, really?
I want him here. I'm not joking. I want Angry MGTOW here right now. I'm like, my gloves are off. I'm ready to go.
No.
Send him the link then.
No.
We gotta be amicable. We can't get all. We can't bully and harass Angry MGTOW, Lacey.
Why?
Because we won't stoop to his level. That's why.
We're not causing any physical harm. We're just telling him how much of a fucking mongoloid he is.
The mongoloid? What? That's what I say in our video. He don't say that shit. That's not right.
That's Roy's line.
Come, we're
you're a darling.
You albinoid mongoloid.
Well, now a gal's getting involved. Now what the hell do we do?
I don't know. I don't know how to fix this. It's gone horribly awry. But but yeah, that did annoy us, the fact that so many people did fucking clips for us and everything, and that was a video taken down. It wouldn't have been so bad otherwise. And so obviously with the next one, we were like, well, we want to go bigger and get more clips from people. You know, which we did. We got way more clips than we ever had for that first one. The clips amount to about the cameos are like 6 minutes long in that last one we did.
You know what? If I could talk to MGTOW right now, I'd be so calm and lovely to begin with. And then I'd go off on one of him. Just go.
Well, fuck it. Oh. Someone sent me the link, but.
Here we go. Come on.
He won't join. No, he might join.
Keep roboting out, though.
Come on.
He really likes Lacey. Like.
Who doesn't? No, I don't mean like as in as a person. I mean, who doesn't like
Lacey?
What? I'm sorry. For some reason?
Yeah.
Have you seen how beautiful I am, darling?
Oh, no. I'm saying.
I'm sorry. I just went to his channel and his new video is stronger than before. MGTOW.
Oh, wait. Do you mean stronger than before, or do you mean stronger than before?
Well, I don't know. He's got flames as the thumbnail. So. And considering this is up after the Angry MGTOW channel is closing, sign up for VidMe. That was put up 6 hours ago, and then followed by 6 minutes ago, the stronger than before. Like, okay, you had to delete all your videos and you're stronger than before. Why? Because you're on VidMe? What the fuck?
It's such a proud MGTOW.
Yeah, he's joining VidMe, which is never going to last. He's not going to stay on VidMe. He's just going to keep doing YouTube because that's where all these fucking cancerous subscribers are.
That's where the money is.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Apparently you can make money on VidMe as well.
Well, yeah, but at the moment it doesn't seem like it's on the same scale as YouTube.
Well, no, but if you get enough people going over that way, it will. It's kind of like you need the people to follow.
I mean, if anybody here is on VidMe, then I've got a channel. I've just been uploading my my other videos, but...
yeah, I've been meaning to.
Hello, you guys hearing us? Well,
we didn't for a bit there. You keep cutting out. Like that. You just cut out again.
Roy.
Yeah, hello. Can you hear me properly?
No, yeah.
Yeah, it might do that from time to time. Yeah, the thing is, you can't monetize your videos on VidMe, can you?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
And they also have an easier tip feature as well. Apparently, they have like a tip feature right on the videos and that. I haven't looked too much into it. I've just heard rumors that like it's a lot more friendly that way.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
A subscription service, or you can pay $1 a month, I think, kind of like a Patreon style thing built in.
You know, for such a pervert, you're such a cute little voice.
For me. Well, I certainly hope so. No, that again. Why am I receiving a compliment?
Yeah, someone just said that mine's is the only one with no hate speech clause, and I have to say that that's for now. See, people look at it, mine's is like, well, they're never going to censor, and they're never going to do this, that, or the other thing. But what are you going to do when they start putting up pedophile content, and they start, you know, like, you're going to want that censored, aren't you? Yeah. And what's going to happen when they actually start getting advertisers in who have demands? And all advertisers have demands. They all want certain things. It's just how it is. Like, a good documentary is the greatest movie ever sold, I think it is, or something along those lines. And basically the plot of the whole documentary is him going around trying to get sponsors for his movie. And that's it. That's the documentary. And then all the things he's got to do, according to them, like all the hoops they make him jump through in order to get that money and to have their products in his film.
I've heard about it, but I haven't actually seen the film.
It's actually really good.
Greatest.
What's the thing? People like Mines is in its infancy, so they can claim whatever they want. And as it stands, not a lot of people are really following people there. Like when I look at someone like Barry, who's on there, like when he posts a video, he gets like, you know, 300 likes.
Yeah.
It's like barely any interaction compared to what he gets on YouTube.
No. At the moment, it's not really an incentive, but I guess if people stick with it and allow it to grow a little, as long as it doesn't turn completely retarded like Twitter.
Well, the other thing I'm not really particularly fond of, although it's neat, is the boost feature, because that's where they get their money from at the moment, is when people buy boost points. But a boost, like a view, is just showing up on somebody's feed, and so I've seen the same video twice in my feed, so it'll be like, you open it up, it'll be there, and then it'll be like four down in the list, which means that's two views. So someone potentially paid, and like I just did two views in one viewing without ever clicking. Like it should be by interaction, not by just being on a feed.
See, I could get into Mines if it wasn't just so pretentious.
I don't like the full blogs in your face either. When like the, especially if it's like a promoted one and you have to like scroll for like a minute to get past it just to see what people you are actually following have posted. Like
the interface has a lot to be desired.
It will all change
to code it and condense it and whatnot, but that's like that's another off-putting thing the moment.
It will all change as soon as money gets involved. It doesn't matter.
Oh, yeah. Like, it always does.
Yeah. I mean, as soon as...
Like, people think they're going to get away with the things they couldn't get away with on YouTube, they're going to get away with on VidMe. And it's like, for how long? You know?
Yeah. For a little while they will, and until they've got a bunch of fucking advertisers that want this and that. And as soon as they get them, they're going to have to, well, you make a choice. Do you want money or not? And any business is going to go with money.
And the funny thing is, like, most people's cases, it's just a matter of changing their language. If you just, you know, hey, don't use foul language, and suddenly you'll be advertiser friendly. For most of them, anyway. I mean, yeah, certain subjects will never be appropriate. And that's just how it is. But otherwise, it's just language. You know, tone down the language, or just switch it. You know, be a little wittier, and you won't have a problem.
Oh, fuck that. That's no fun.
Well, fuck, I know, but, you know. That's what live streams are for. Then you can swear your fucking head off and have a great old fucking time. Fuck yeah.
I love hearing you swear. You don't swear that much in your videos. It's so wonderful to hear it here.
Yeah, I know. Every now and then it slips and I don't do another take. I just leave it in. Like, fuck it. It was a good take. I just fucked up by swearing.
It's fine. Like, all you need is the subscriber base. That's it. You can make money despite yourself. It doesn't matter. If you've got enough subscribers, you'll make money whether you're able to monetize your videos or not. Whether that be through fucking Patreon or merchandise sales. If you've got like 100 subscribers, 200 subscribers, you can do that shit as a job. It doesn't matter. If most of your videos are demonetized, yeah, you'll make money because you've got the fan base. It doesn't matter. It's not, you know, like, the thing is, when we're hearing about this demonetization thing, we make fuck all from ads. We make nothing from ads compared to Patreon. We make all our money through Patreon.
Oh, look at Logic. I mean, he like overnight, he just put up one video and was like, yeah, I don't make any AdSense anymore. If you guys want me to keep doing this, you're going to have to put on my Patreon. And then by the next morning, he had more than enough to keep doing it.
Exactly.
It's all about the quality of your content.
Well, that's the thing. You got to have the content.
Yeah.
It's hard to do comedy when you're depressed.
Well, yeah.
Oh, sure. Sure. I mean, you know... obviously, comedy doesn't necessarily equal good content. It could be anything.
That's what I like to do. That's one of the things
really
I like.
Fucking clever.
That's like my music and my comedy are my two shortest playlists now. I wanted them to be equal, but like my awareness one is like fucking huge, and my rants is quite bigger than it should be. Like, they should all be quite in proportion, in my opinion. I wanted to keep it a good variety, but oh well. One day I'll get back to it.
But you know what? There's a certain reason people come to you for your, like, bitching about things. You know, that's like the thing that really allures everyone.
I think it's just because I'm so adorable. I don't think most people care what I do.
Oh, we're not arguing about that.
It's all about the voice.
Oh, yes. The sweet, sexy Canadian accent.
Oh, yeah.
I'll do my best. I'll do my best girl impression. I'm such a great pop. All back in streets. Nailed it.
Okay, we missed half of it, but I came anyway.
Yeah, we're drunk again. I just want to reiterate that.
Yeah,
again. You mean still?
Yeah, still, that's like,
we're more drunk than when we started. We keep progressively getting more drunk as we're going along.
Isn't that the idea?
Yeah, it is.
So, end of the day, you know what? If you get pissed, people take the piss out of you, but at least you can just laugh at it afterwards. So that's better in my mind.
Oh, I can't. I find it hard to listen back to any stream I've ever been on. I don't like it at all. I don't do it.
The only stream I've ever really gone back and watched again was the one where it was on Danny the Dingo's channel, and it was when Markov O'Muffin hopped into the chat and started slandering, like spewing shit, and we invited him into the stream, and we just fucking ripped him a new one. And then he came back. It was like, I think it was the following week, he came back again and was like spouting his mouth off, and then we pulled him in the stream and we just fucking tore him a new one again. And it wasn't long after that he ended up deleting his channel and coming back as the Red Pill Ghost.
One sec. Seepage, can you send Angry MGTOW a link?
Okay. I mean,
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Kevin.
I'll see what I can do. I don't have him.
Hey, I'm going to go to the bathroom now, and I'm going to come back with my fucking.
You guys have
golden praise.
Yeah. You guys have the link.
I was going to say, you guys joined the stream. You have the link. You have the power.
And he actually knows you. I mean.
Yeah.
Hang on. One sec. I'm going to have to copy it from your DMs if that's cool.
That is totally fine.
That's usually how you do it.
Oh no, I was talking to Lacey. I'm gonna have to go into his DMs to get it.
No.
Oh, I'd like to go into
his DMs. You can't go into my DMs, right? Please. Stave.
Yeah. I like that. We just went with these awful sort of East End English accents. Do you know Frank Spencer?
I do. He still love him as
a kid. If you we really went with a Frank Spencer vibe with them characters there. We were like, we'll just talk like Frank Spencer for absolutely no reason. I don't know why we did that,
but it worked. It was amusing. Highly.
Well, amusing. I hope so.
Oh yeah, I fapped multiple times.
Oh well, I'm glad. That's why we're in this. We're not in it for subscribers or money or to, you know, just to have our opinions heard. We're in it for the fapping.
I can say Very Nearly Viral is probably my largest source of fap material on YouTube.
Oh, that's what I like to hear. That is what I like to fucking hear.
It's mostly because of Lacey, but. Hey, on occasion, I do fap to you, Roy.
Oh, fuck you. That's ridiculous.
Oh, come on. Just look at that sweet, innocent face that hides such a dark and disturbed interior. it just makes you want to reach your hand down your pants and, you know, throw off a load.
Oh, that's what I like to hear, man. I mean... Like I say, I get joy. Like, you know what? I honestly wonder, like, do you reckon people have actually masturbated to our shit?
Oh, look, probably.
Like, honestly, like, I think a couple people probably have.
Not to our actual stuff, but I imagine maybe to fantasies.
Yeah, I you know what? I'm sure someone's put that shit on in the background and had a wank or a nice finger bashing session.
It's possible.
Yeah.
I mean, I've seen on Twitter a few comments from gay guys. Especially about Lacey. I'm pretty sure people fap to you.
I think Roy's like such a sub. I don't get it.
I think that's got a lot to do with the whole retarded thing.
It could be.
No, I mean, Roy is obviously quite dominant, but I don't know. Yeah.
I don't know, man. I've hugged both of them, and I think Lacey's the dominant one.
But really, does Lacey look like they could dominate anyone? They wear pigtails and makeup.
Not physically, at least. I think he can be quite manipulative. I think you're strong emotionally.
Yeah, this is
psychological warfare on Roy. Get him to do your bidding.
Everyone has my character so wrong.
Yeah, this is bollocks. I'm clearly a fucking alpha male. Okay.
You can hide behind that beard all you want, but we know what it's for, and it's a cum catcher.
Yeah. We know.
I would love to feel that. You know, I think it'd be quite stiff and crusty.
And we did that fucking the suit yourself collaboration, and he's squeezing shampoo all over my face.
Oh, did you see the gist?
Yeah.
That was good.
But like the bits that got in my beard, it literally just hung there. It stayed.
Like
it was all one take, and then the bit in the shower, it was the same shit you squeezed on my face on that previous take, and the shit just hung in my beard, man. It just stayed. It like just caught it really well.
Yeah.
Just refused to leave. And I had fucking water going.
All I can say is like that video was so much fun to make, but is he coming? I'm ready. Come on.
Oh no, I don't know. He might come in. I sent the link to MGTOW, so he may pop up at some point.
Oh, we can only hope.
I don't know if you guys know, but I'm extremely pissed off with that person, and I'm
Yeah, we've noticed.
Yeah. Oh, dude, you'll fucking break his heart. He fucking loves you, though.
Yeah.
The first thing I'll say is, like, Angry Mugtow, I think you're the worst person I've ever talked to in my life.
Well, what about the whole building up to it bit? You know?
Yeah, you gotta build up to it.
You gotta do the foreplay before you have the climax. You know
what? Yeah.
That's how I'll do it. That's the best way to go.
What's his gay little intro? Angry Mugtow here.
I'll be like, yes, he is. He's so angry. Such a beautiful person.
Look at all those MGTOWs going their own way together.
Those happy little MGTOWs.
But at least we all share a hand together, right, guys?
Well, I'm just really interested. I want to question a little bit. I just want to question his motives and things. It's like, why have you been doing this as of late? I mean, the fucking Angie stream and stuff, and the SDA stream. I mean, well, we can get into the fucking whole doxing thing after that.
And well, we don't want to give too much away, darling, at the same time.
No, you can't have an answer for that. There's no reasonable answer to that. It doesn't really matter. It's pretty irrelevant what he says.
Yeah.
There's nothing he can say that makes that okay.
No.
I mean, again, like, the thing is, I watched that stream, and no matter how perverse you are, I can't believe that I skip halfway through a session of a stream and just find a guy asking a girl how many times she's been fucked in her life.
Oh, here he is.
Yeah. Roy, hello? Listen, I didn't know that you were going to have Eagle in here. I'm not in the mood for arguing with these people.
What do you mean these people?
These people.
What do you mean?
I think that's a bird.
What's a bird?
What?
Yeah, who's Eagle?
She's been cutting out your nose.
Okay. I'm sure we can have a moderately civilized conversation here.
Listen, I mean,
okay, angry. So, what's been your fucking train of thought over that you've done with stuttering soliloquy and SDA? What were you thinking?
What? Okay. What about them?
Okay, so.
Well, it's kind of clear, but you should obviously know what he's talking about.
Listen, like I've spoken to you a bunch of times, right? I've done a good few streams of you at this point. I've spoken to you, off air and shit, and you seem like quite an all right guy. You know, I don't agree with you on any on everything. I disagree with you on a lot of things. And
no, we don't agree with you on many things.
And I've got that out there, and you've been perfectly amicable to talk to. But yeah, so let's just start off with the Angie's restoring soliloquy. What?
You're breaking in and out for me. It might be my internet connection. It's probably really.
No, it's them. They've been kind of doing this off and on. So I guess you have to bear with them a little bit.
You coming through okay now?
Yeah.
Barely, but continue. We'll deal with it.
Okay. So, yeah. So what, like, did you get, like, stuttering soliloquy on just to sort of ambush her?
Stuttering? No. I mean, honestly, it's a one-on-one conversation, okay?
Yeah.
And she was holding a gun to her head. At that point, she had a couple of options. She could have left if she wanted to. Again, that's the thing. And first off, the thing about what I do when I bring people on, I do let them talk. They can argue, they can curse, they can say whatever they want to. It's a one-on-one with me. I won't always get along with everyone that I bring on.
I mean, yeah, like, because you were like, you were screaming at her about what, I don't know.
And she could have screamed back. Again, she's not a child. She's not a little girl. Okay. Or she could argue. She had those choices. And to say you don't have to know the way that I spoke to her, but you do have to.
But
someone held a gun to her head to be there.
But MGTOW, you're not a child either, and there was no reason for you to start screaming at her.
But that's the thing, Lacey, you have to understand. Comes down to it, am not trying to be better.
No, you have to understand basic human morality and how to treat people in a decent sense, and you didn't do that.
Lacey, let me tell you something. I like you as a person, so I'll treat you like a person, but there are certain people they rub me the wrong way. And not in the United States. You're not in the U.S. You don't know some of the crazy things that are happening around us. And I've learned that at the end of the day, these people, they don't have the basic moral fiber that you think they do. And you can't fight fire with inaction. You have to. I mean, you fight back however you choose to fight back, and you rant however you choose to rant. You can say that you don't like the way I interact. You can say that it's not right the way I interact. But you should not. You should never say I'm not allowed to interact the way I do. If I want to yell at someone, it's my basic human right to do so. No. She could have left at any time.
Right, but you still should understand that if you disagree with what she had to say, that's fine. And if you appreciate MGTOW, fine. But you had no right to make her look awful like that for no reason. I mean, I skipped halfway through the stream. Wait, let me finish. I skipped halfway through the stream, and you just asked her how many dicks she had inside of her. Like, that's pretty disgusting, dude.
Again, she could have left at any time she wanted to.
But you didn't need to ask that question.
Lacey, I have joked about you having AIDS for like 2 weeks straight.
But you're actually asking about someone for no good reason.
I asked you the same question when we were on stream about about guys you fucked.
Yeah. It's a little different about the relationship you guys have, though. Like, you know each other and you interact with each other. So it's a little bit different because, like, he knows you're joking.
At the end of the day, I'm not in a box. You don't have to like what I say. Yeah. You can call me an asshole. You can call me any name you want, but you can't tell me I don't have the right to say it. By saying that I don't have the right to say it, you're literally policing what is acceptable from what is unacceptable language.
It doesn't mean you don't have the right. It just means that it's highly inappropriate.
That's perfectly fine. Ego, you don't understand.
Wait. Don't get me wrong. Listen. Don't get me wrong.
Let me talk, Roy.
Shut up.
Let me shout.
Shut the fuck up for a second.
Hey, don't. I mean, okay. Over there. Don't be Lacey.
So
nobody puts Lacey in the corner.
I'm keeping fucking Lacey in check at the moment. What? I mean, like, so was this all character based? Honestly, was this like a was it an act with the stuttering soliloquy? publicly stream. I'm not talking about the SDA stream. I'm talking about the story stream. Was that all sort of an act? Was that all character?
It's a mixture of both. I mean, here I am talking to you right now, and when I'm on my stream, I utilize the angry persona because that helps to resonate with a lot of guys. A lot of the things I brought up, it's about the way that you position things. For example, there is truth within the comedy or within some of the comments that you deem as mean. It's just my form of delivery. Talking about the number of dicks that she, you know, has inside her talks about hypergamy. It also challenges her views and her behavior. Again, the way I said it, you may say that it was obscene, it was disrespectful, it was a number of things. Again, that's just the way I choose to deliver my message. Not everyone will like what I say, many people won't, but again, it was a mixture of two.
So do you not think you're was the reason you did that because you have to pander to your fucking crazy ass fucking subscribers that are fairly in. Like, I look through your comments sometimes, and these guys are fucking knobheads. Like, they're proper sort of knob.
Actually, decent.
You can say whatever you want. Listen, right. Those are the guys who have been there with me through a lot of things. I know you. I know how you feel about the community, and you have every. You're free to feel the way you want to feel. You're free to say whatever you want to say. But again, a lot of those guys. My content resonates with them, and they resonate with me.
Fine.
And again, if it is in the name, the Angry MGTOW.
Right, yeah.
See, I knew it. We were talking about this a little bit earlier, and I knew that it wasn't all just character. I knew the angry part was a bit of a character, but I knew all the philosophy and all that was true. So that is all 100% true, though. You believe all those things, and everything you say is, like, you believe your the things that you show to people. It's just the angry part is the character.
So did this happen?
Go ahead.
Go on. What are you saying? Actually, go on. Speak first. Go on.
So yeah, different elements of the philosophy I do insert, and I do believe in that. But the anger—it's that's how I position it. There are times when I am absolutely angry.
Well, I was trying to understand because you had said that it was just a character, and I was trying to understand like just how deep did the character go because it did not come across as purely a character in a lot of situations, especially like the last stream we're on together when like you just couldn't handle the fact there was a feminist in the chat.
Like, also you got to understand if you're playing a character, she didn't know you were doing so therefore it just came across as like being really like a big assault on her.
You have to understand that I, you know, doing the persona is not always going to be perfect. There are going to be times when I go off track, and there are times when I'm actually going to get upset and frustrated because I am a human being, and I am doing it in the persona at that time.
But you are a human being, and you have to realize that the women you talk to are also human beings, and you shouldn't treat them like scumbags for no absolute reason. Even if you're playing a character, you have to know they might not be in the joke.
Listen, they can leave at any time. I'll give you a good example. A bit of Brit knows, she knows exactly what I'm about, all right? And I did a lot of the same shit with her, and she gets it, okay? But some people can't stand up to it. Now, when it came down to what do you call her, some dumb American? I'll be honest, when she started talking about the fact that MGTOW are men who can't get laid, I got angry because she basically began positioning sex, you know, women, positioning that women are gatekeepers of sex. That did definitely got me upset. And then when Jeff Holliday claims that she gave him the link and then he's the one who leaked the link to Twitter. And that's when my stream began to get bombarded. And I mean, again, she could have left at any time she wanted to. I understand where you're coming from, Lacey, but
fine.
It's my place to be.
Fine. Okay, like, MGTOW, you've always been very respectful and very wonderful. I appreciate it. You helped us grow. Well, like, by a sub. Thanks. And she was the best. And the way
you're breaking up, I can't hear anything.
Pick. But
no, you're cutting out, darling.
The other issue.
What the hell?
Well, I heard
not me either. Sorry, but you were cutting out a little bad.
Can you hear me? Are we coming through okay?
It's pretty bad at the moment.
Okay, one sec. Can you hear us now? Are we coming through okay?
I can hear you, Roy.
A little better, still kind of robot-y.
Can you hear us?
Yes, Roy.
Come on.
Did you try turning down the audio? Try turning down the bandwidth just to audio only?
No, hello? Can you hear us now? Is that all right?
Yeah, hopefully you're still cutting in a little, but I can hear you.
Can you? Are we coming through okay?
In a little. Did you turn down the bandwidth to audio only?
Hang on one sec. One sec. What about that one?
Jeez, you think you guys live in a third world country?
I guess I do, really.
Oh, yeah, you know what?
Fair enough. Rapid migration, kind of going in that direction.
Hello, can you hear us?
Yes. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Are we coming through our...
nope. Okay. Just as Cersei gets better, it goes down again.
Oh, okay. I don't know what's going on. So something's happening. One sec.
I don't space it down.
If we're okay now?
I think so. Keep talking.
Hello, hello, hello. Can you hear us?
Jason, Roy, tell us about your childhood.
There was something about telling us about your childhood.
Yes, we're putting you on the couch now.
Guys, are you done with questions? Because I heard Lacey say something, and he was trying to say something. You said that you've always been very nice, and then you completely broke out. I didn't hear what you said, Lacey.
Well, are you getting a voice clip?
You're gone again, dude. Maybe you guys should try leaving and then coming back in.
Yeah.
That might be advisable.
Even join this
room. Of course, there's loads of people in the chat who want to join, but...
wow. Sure, man, people really do follow the drama, don't they?
Yeah.
Where the hell were all you viewers before when it was an entertaining talk about sexy things?
Well, that's how it started.
That is how it started.
And I was hoping to get Lacey alone for a little while to try and wheedle some nudes out of him, but...
I know, and he's definitely in the right frame of mind to do it, too.
Yes, yes.
I'm kind Hello? Of distracted
by other things.
Hello?
Can you hear us okay?
Yeah.
Yeah? Is that all right? Sounds okay. Good. All right, yeah. Nice one. So we're back. So, MGTOW, I mean, did you not do these, like, because this seemed a bit overly aggressive for you. Like, I know you've done crazy fucking, I know you've done crazy streams on your own and shit that I've watched and I've laughed at. And I'm like, this is funny as fuck, right? But like, lately, it seemed you were like, you know, getting these sort of...
Well, listen, thanks for inviting me, but you guys are, you know, you guys are just, we can't hear you.
Yeah, it's kind of cutting out. I mean, whatever. I'm kind of curious what the hell you were thinking with the whole Jeff Holiday thing there. That was like a cluster fucking a half.
Jeff Holiday thing.
What do you mean? That fucking bad?
What exactly do you mean?
Well, I just know what I saw on Twitter, like you threatening to get his kid taken away and dox him and shit. Like, what was going on there? Like, I don't do drama. I'm just, like, going by what I've seen.
Well, let me ask you a question. Did I post that publicly?
That wasn't my question.
Well, it's relevant. Did I say any of that stuff publicly?
I don't know, because I don't go around checking everybody's videos and seeing what was said where. I'm only asking based on what possessed you to even try to do that. Like, I was just curious. Well, were you that mad at them?
Well, after my stream got attacked and people started flooding in, and Jeff decided that, you know, basically calling me a straight out pole, I, you know, in Ginger, we thought we were friends, and I was, you know, I got frustrated, was mouthing off to Ginger, and I didn't send any of that to, I didn't send any of that to Jeff, or I didn't send anything to anybody, but I was just frustrated, and, you know, I was talking to Ed Indro, and then he basically sent all of that over to Jeff, and Jeff basically retweeted it, and some dumb American basically retweeted it, and I never actually said anything about CPS, and I'm not suddenly Hello? Back.
Okay.
Yes.
Can you hear us? Are we coming through?
So it was just you were venting to a friend and someone you thought was a friend, and it got leaked out, and then it got blown completely out of proportion.
Can you guys hear us?
Yes, we can hear you.
Can you hear us?
Yes, we can hear you, sweet Lacey. But yeah, Eggle, what ended up happening is I was just ranting to a friend.
It's called Eggle. That's how his name's pronounced.
Eggle. All right.
Doesn't matter.
So, yeah, I was just ranting to a friend, and he basically sent it over to Jeff, and Jeff basically put it out there. To be very honest, it was actually pretty interesting because I never used the word CPS. I simply said that, you know, look at the shit he's doing online. And I just imagine if his son's parent, if it, okay. just
imagine. Right. Imagine may I stop you in your tracks for a moment?
Go ahead. What, Lacey?
Like, you've always been very nice to me. You've always been very sweet, and I appreciate that. You shared our video, and thank you very much. You've always been very kind. And all your problems with the you talk to, whilst I very much disagree with your opinions, they were your opinions. But you went after someone's kids.
Did I?
Yeah,
I'm trying to.
It seemed that way.
That's what I was asking him, Lacey. It was just like he didn't. He was venting and, like, I guess said the wrong thing to the wrong person who took it the wrong way, and then the internet does blows drama out of proportion.
I'd never get caught in that situation because I'd never say anything that fucking retarded.
Let me finish.
Go for it.
So basically, I said that, and I was saying that, you know, I could report it to his kid's school, so it's, you know, they know what his father's doing online. And I also brought up the point that this guy, you know, he's talked about pot use in the past, and I questioned whether or not he had been using drugs around his kid. At that point, these are the things I said to Ed. And then somehow he took that as meaning that I was going to get CPS involved. Now, realistically, if I were to actually report it to the school, then yeah, CPS could definitely get involved. These were things that I said privately. I didn't say them publicly. I didn't make any videos discussing it on my channel. Who the hell is Little? Oh gosh, fuck Little Miss Anonymous. Listen, I don't have time for this shit right now.
No, listen, it's fine. It's fine. Don't worry about it.
I was in another chat the other day. I don't have time for this shit. I am really not in the mood. Get her out or I get out. Your choice.
Listen, why are we inviting other people into this? We were doing this stuff fine.
MGTOW, you know, end of the day, you just know common sense and not to be a fucking cunt to people. Is that so hard to understand?
Yet again, you can vent sometimes. And I was venting privately, and Angel put it out there, and then...
It's not private if you're doing it against another person that everyone can see, is it?
Well, how did I put it out there to where everyone could see it?
No, but the thing is, right, I'd never be so stupid to talk about fucking doxing people and talking about people's kids.
Okay, my channel got flagged after Jeff Holliday did what he did. channel got flagged after that video. There were people saying, flag Angry MGTOW's channel. And then I got first community guideline strike. And after I got my community guideline strike,
listen,
that's what got off to Edindro.
You fucking, why are you pissed off at Edindro? You're saying some crazy fucking insane bullshit to him. What's he supposed to do with that? Is he supposed to keep that a secret and be like, oh, he's talking about Jeff Holliday's kids and stuff? And
I'm gonna keep the only thing secret. I ever said in that was that his kids' school should know what his father is doing online.
Why? What? No, no, no. Doxed where he Why? Lived, listen. Yeah, what? What? Obviously, he's not going to be. He's not going to be cool with that. He's not going to be fine.
Listen to me. That's not a crime. Telling the school what this guy's doing online. That's not a crime.
Well, that's not a crime.
Okay. There's no
way. Invade and ruin his life is when he's.
But how is wrong. That? All right, Lacey. How is that a crime? How is telling them, hey, just so you know, you have a student that has.
So the crime he committed was he makes YouTube videos. Holy shit! Let's hang it from the gallows. Is that what you're talking about?
It's not a crime. It's just a dick move.
No, it's perfectly fine. It's not a dick move. It's a complete pussy.
You can call Lacey, call it what you want. But again, it wasn't a crime.
I see it, and you're being a horrible person for doing so incriminating.
And talking about his drug use and questioning if he's been doing pot around his son. That's not a crime. Bringing up
hang on. You don't know that. What the fuck? You think he's smoking weed and blowing it into his kid's face? Is that what you're assuming?
I don't know what he's been doing.
Exactly. Exactly.
For some reason, you victimize him then. Because he might smoke pot? Oh my God, the world's going to fall apart from that, right?
Again. But now, you know what is a crime? Doing that around a kid that's very young, that can impair their cognitive.
You know,
you're assuming that he does it in the same room. And I think that is their point. Yeah. Like I used it for pain management myself, and I never smoked it around my child, but I did was on it.
No, it's funny. It's funny. You say like smoking pot around a child is bad, but you're threatening to dox where this person lives, where their child lives, and the school they go to. Yeah, I wonder which one's worse.
Before we go any further, Jeff's in the chat. And I think
I don't have time for him now.
Sorry,
I don't have time for him now.
Listen,
I don't need to have an argument right now. If you want me to listen,
listen. Can you see why? Like, we think this is a problem. Can you see why we think this may be out of order? Do you comprehend that?
Listen, here's the thing. My channel is, I'm moving off the platform. I'm really relaxed and cool right now. Shit happened, and I am just going to move forward with it. Jeff did what he had to do. I mean, I got a second strike today. False flag my videos, which they did as well. And again, that's what started the whole thing. And that's why I went off privately to Edindro after it happened the first time. But
I am.
Happen again. This is it's over. I'm already moving away from the YouTube platform.
Dude, I'd like to appreciate your answer. I really like the way you danced around the word no.
Around the word what no?
Yeah, I mean, can you not see though? Like, I get you're moving platform. That's fine, right? Can you not see why the things you said are a massive problem?
I question if the guy did drugs or not.
Fine, but no, you didn't. No, that's bullshit. You didn't just question if he did drugs or not, right? I mean, weed's fine. I smoke weed. It's fine, right? But like, you're not just questioning whether he did drugs or not. You're talking about like leaking his home address. You're talking about getting in contact with the school of his.
I never publicly said I would do these things. I never said that I would actually do them.
What, you never said you'd actually do them?
Never publicly said that I was going to do this. He saw a private message between me and Indro.
Okay, but you're insinuating privately that you want to leak this shit. So what's Edindro to do then?
Again,
should he just
Jeff could have approached me privately and Jeff could approach me privately and he could have said, hey, what is this angry? But no, he chose to put that out there. And then he started blowing up the whole thing. But listen, I got nothing else to lose right now. All right. Jeff has taken it to the point. At this point, everything just needs to burn down to the ground. Jeff, I'm really clear.
Jeff didn't take it to this point. You took it to this point by saying to Adindro.
No, it's perfectly fine. So, I mean, Jeff, he's having fun right now. And, you know, they say, like I said, he who laughs last, laughs best. And I'm going to have the last laugh in this whole situation. Sitting around running my mouth, making streams. I'm going to go silent. I'm going to go dark. I'm not going to be talking as much on this entire situation or anything at all. You know, actions speak louder than words. And what I'm going to do is focus on actually doing and dealing with the Jeff situation privately. Taking action. Have fun with that, bro. I've got nothing left to lose in my life besides my life. And like I said, we've been taken so far. MGTOW's men in general have been chastised, harassed. I mean, like, you know, just what? Our speech? You got to be kidding me.
Listen,
he wants to take it there? Let's go. Let's go FBI. Let's go CIA. Whoa. Let's go NSA.
Oh, God, the robot fight is hilarious.
We're going to get this shit done.
Listen, MGTOW, we're not talking about that. We're not talking about MGTOW at this point. It's gone far beyond that. I mean, when you're talking to Adindro about doxing Jeff, were you you're annoyed that it got leaked, or were you seriously considering doing that? Honestly, were you like, I actually want to fucking dox this guy. I want to get in contact with his fucking kid's school. Was that something that you were honestly considering doing?
If I told you the honest to goodness truth, you wouldn't believe me.
Well, go for it. Charles. Go for it. I mean, what? Did you just have a fucking crazy moment of madness where you were just pissed off and talking shit? Or were you actually planning on doing that shit?
I was extremely pissed off getting a strike on the channel and him bombing the channel over and over, especially when I honestly, sincerely was trying to engage him in conversation. And then his subscribers went and I false flagged my account for like no reason whatsoever. But honestly, I was just ranting.
Right.
Ed Indra went and did that. You can say whatever you want to. I never.
Listen, I mean, right. That's fine. But can you understand why all this has happened? Can you understand why he was extremely pissed off?
I don't give a damn at this point. I have nothing to lose in this life. I'm completely for the cause. We are going to take over. We are going to move forward. We are not going to fail. If Jeff Holler, you can laugh, Roy.
Okay.
Laugh your ass off, Roy. I mean, like I said, you think I'm a joke? You think I'm completely joking right now?
Hey, look, listen, sweetheart. If you want to be a darling retard, that's fine by you. But the McTowers are so definitely good in the world. Of course. All of your opinions are right. Let's just harass the women alive. Let's just kick people out of talks because they disagree with what we have to say. Yeah, you're definitely going the right way forward. 100%.
Yeah, MGTOW have about as much chances to feminazis at this point. You guys are both really two extremes that really not going to work.
You guys don't listen to me. You guys will never agree with anything I say. Jeff Holliday is laughing.
The thing is, we just don't.
He's laughing his ass off. Listen to me. No, I'm done with
it. Right?
I came honestly to
MGTOW, please.
Guys, one at a time, please. Please, one at a time. The robot fight is annoying.
MGTOW. We just don't like agreeing with idiots, okay?
Listen, I don't know how you. I don't know why you you're so adverse to this reaction you've got, and I don't understand why. It's pretty clear when you're talking about people's children and you're talking about their fucking real lives, and it becomes more than just YouTube. why is that so hard to understand that people are very pissed off?
I brought up a valid argument that, hey, does this guy do drugs around his kid? You're actually attacking me for actually bringing up a valid point.
No, I'm not attacking you for bringing that up. Listen, do you know that? Do you know anything about him and his life? Do you know what he does around his fucking children? You don't, do you?
And you're making it sound like he's shooting up heroin. It's fucking marijuana, dude.
Answer the question.
How do you know it's like not even legal where he is? So different than having a few drinks.
In Oregon, it is legal, but it's not legal to use it around a kid.
How do you know he does?
But answer the question.
Again, I don't. I said allegedly. That's right, something that organization like CPS would have to investigate.
Right, so allegedly, but you went very fucking far, didn't you? I mean, you're annoyed that fucking Adindro leaked this shit, but the shit you were saying is serious. I mean, what do you do when you get this insane shit in your DMs? Are you just like, I'll keep it all private, even though he's talking about his children and stuff? I don't blame fucking Adindro for sending that shit to Jeff. That's absolutely fine. It went above and beyond, man. It was too much.
What do you want? What do you want at this point?
Angry, you're roboting quite a bit now.
I don't know why I'm roboting, but I said, what do you want at this point? Talking about that.
Because you've been beaten.
Yeah.
I've been beaten.
Listen, it's...
That's you perfectly went, fine. If you think so.
You went way too far, man. Like I was fine at the point. I thought this was all just a dumb act and it was for controversy and views and stuff, and that's okay. You can do what the fuck you want. You can attack as many women online as you want to attack, and that's all well and good. I don't have to agree with it, and I can think you're a total cunt. But at the point you're talking about doxing people and children and things like that, like, that's fine. And you kind of deserve the fucking backlash you've got off of this.
I mean, like, you're not just doxing them. You're doxing their literal children. Fucked up, dude.
Yeah, and we're probably only going to make it worse.
Angry, he's still there.
No, I don't know. He may have pussied out. He doesn't seem to understand the sort of severity.
It could just be his connection, you know. He's been here this whole time. He showed up. He's been selling his points. He's just, you know, just like you guys, he's got a bad connection. So I imagine he's having difficulty. He's probably speaking right now. We're just not hearing it.
Sure, probably.
That's just the excuse.
No, I don't know. I don't know.
No, if he wanted to leave, he would leave. He's made that one very clear right at the very beginning. If someone wants to leave the conversation, they can.
So when
he's holding the gun to his head, he doesn't have to stay.
Yeah, I guess we won't kick him like he kicked fucking SDA or Jeff. Yeah. Oh, he's gone. Fuck him.
Oh, he might be back.
He might be.
Oh, we'll see.
Maybe.
I'm hoping he doesn't come back because he's a fucking scumbag. So.
And I can talk now. Because you won't run away.
Welcome, Adon.
Hi.
It's nice to have you on.
Yeah, yeah,
you'll never see a MGTOW lose their shit faster than when there's a lady present.
I'm going to do this. I know it's a bit weird. I will probably gonna have to leave soon because of it. But I'm just going to do this. I'm going to give my earphone to my brother. He's the troll in our videos. So is my little brother, Dominic. Just letting everyone say hello to him.
G'day, you know, is Jeff still in the chat or is he fucked off?
No, he's streaming soon, I think. So.
Yeah, he left. He said he's got to go do his show, so.
No, oh, okay. Hang on. Here's Liam's brother, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Howdy.
I was very confused. I didn't really realize what I walked into.
Oh, it's quite the clusterfuck.
The thing is, I always found Angry MGTOW to be quite funny. Like, I think he's stupid, and I think his beliefs are stupid, but I always found him quite funny.
Unfortunately, he takes himself so seriously.
I always laugh whenever they think that MGTOW's going to take over the world. Like, I'm sorry. And then when you try to oppose them, it's, go back to the plantation. Your slavery.
Well, Liam and Jason were just like you've gone too far. I'm like, what's he done? What could it be? And then people start talking about kids. I'm like, what's he doing? What's happened? But I think I kind of know, but it still sounds pretty bad, I think.
Yeah. I think it was blown out of proportion, but it's really hard to tell. It's like, basically, one of the big no-nos is you don't go after somebody's kids, even in like a private conversation with someone who is your friend, because if they happen to be friends with the other person, they're probably going to go, hey, dude, this guy says he's going to go after your kids, which is pretty much exactly what happened.
Well, someone give me the short story, because obviously Liam and Jason were part of the chat, so I couldn't.
I don't know what the whole thing. About. Basically, he pulled. He got a girl onto a live stream and berated her quite nastily, like the way he likes to do, because, you know, he has no respect for women. And then she invited Jeff in. Jeff tore him a new one, as all males do. He can't handle males. That's why he didn't want me here. And then that pissed him off. And then he was venting to another guy who he said that he was going to report him for smoking drugs around his kid, which then got reported back to Jeff, the guy who tore him a new one in the stream, and then it got published onto Twitter and the shit.
Right.
Man. That's all.
And
I
afterwards he doubled down. That's I think that's what triggered most people, instead of immediately going for the I was shit talking because I was angry at him in private and I wasn't actually planning on doing it. He doubled down. And he started saying things like, oh, Jeff's going to lose his kids. Aha, how so funny. And his fans were doing the same thing.
Oh, see, yeah. That's convenient that he left that out. Like, if he would have, of course he goes to the defense of, well, it was just a private convo. I wasn't actually going to do that. Okay.
Well, the thing is, can I ask you guys, you know, when it comes to MGTOW, because me and Jason, we spoke about this many a times.
Mm.
In my head, I think it's either someone who's been really bad with women his whole life, or he's had like a really bad relationship. Do you reckon that's about right?
It's actually a mix. There is basically two sects of MGTOW. There is the ones who were actually legitimately hurt. They need a break. They don't actually hold all women accountable, like the crazy one. Now, the crazy ones, as I understand it, were actually... a lot of them were spousal abusers. Like, they abused their wives left, hosed them in the divorce, and then now they hold a resentment against all women, and they try to do this alpha male bullshit.
Well, there's a third
sect.
Jeez,
fuck me up. All women are awful.
There's a third circle.
Political MGTOWs, who are essentially just opting out of the legal contract with women until they're less biased towards men.
Yeah, I've heard about that.
Oh, okay.
Yes, that's a perfectly respectable position. But they're preemptively
butthurt ones, I call them.
Yeah.
Because they look at what the other guys went through who were legitimately hurt, and they're preemptively butthurt that they may have to go through that. And it's like, you know what? It's really not that bad. Don't be an asshole. Have open communication. Make sure that your goals line up before you really get there. Make sure the mental connection is present, and things go pretty good.
It's not always a guarantee.
Well, no, it's not a guarantee. I mean, shit, my marriage did not end particularly well, but we were adults about it.
That's not always purely
civilized, right?
Well, yeah, we still resided in the same residence for a few months. I mean, yeah, like, you know, it wasn't pleasant for me per se, but otherwise we ended it quite like adults. It's the best way to put it.
I think
there was no punches thrown, at least.
Yeah.
No. I'm not a violent person.
The MGTOWs I'm talking about are essentially protesting the imbalance in things like child courts and like divorce courts that are heavily biased towards women.
Oh, is that like angry? Because he's the real MRA. I've heard him say that many times.
What, angry MGTOW?
Yeah, he's angry. Real MRA. You guys, those guys aren't real MRA, because we're the real MRA, because we're MGTOW.
No, you're getting it wrong, girl. Sorry, darling, you're getting it so wrong. It's more like, women, the hatred.
Sorry, it's hard to do. I have sizable testicles, and they have descended, so it's very difficult to do that voice.
Is that the Canadian man?
Yes, it is.
That's the Canadian.
Very beautiful man.
That's an oxymoron. Yeah.
He's gay, but he doesn't realize yet.
You've got a strong jawline.
Oh, thank you, sir.
I've been thinking, though, when it comes to MGTOW, I mean, do people know where we live?
Why what do you mean? That
well, we live in Manchester. and I've been.
Yeah,
no.
Yeah, you guys totally doxed in that video I was in.
Yeah,
we showed the airport.
Well, I've been looking up MGTOW groups in Manchester, and I don't believe anything MGTOWs believe. I love women, but I want to start going to the meetings in secret. I really want to speak to him and just start. I don't know.
Going like a secret spy, like, you know, going like, hi, my name is Snake.
I just want to go with a hitting camber. I want to be like, yeah, I fucking hate women. Me, tell me
they're
why you're
gonna come
hate
out one of them.
Yeah, they might convert. Give it like 2 years. I'll be the new Angry MGTOW.
There are some retarded. I think there was one stream I was on with a couple people. I think it was like Minty Fox and her hubby or whatever. And we were going through these different MGTOW videos. And the one that I think it was by Sandman. And basically, the premise of the video is that women's vaginas secrete brain controlling juices that go into you, and they control your mind.
That makes so much sense. Of course, vagina controls how my brain works.
Well, that makes sense to me, to be honest.
Yeah, makes perfect sense.
Oh, it was fucking hilarious. Like,
I thought that was boobs.
No, it was the vagina juice.
Much more fascinating.
So that's why I want to have sex with Lacey. Because there's no vaginal juices to soak up and
you know that you actually had intercourse when it's Lacey with a woman. No, it's you don't know. You were brainwashed into thinking that you actually had intercourse when you didn't actually have intercourse.
Well, yeah, you feel dirty the next day, don't you? You have to take a big shower.
Oh yes.
You don't know what you're gonna get.
Yeah. Honestly, though, I don't understand what the fucking problem is. It's like he seems to not understand why it was bad, the things that he did or said.
Well, like, can I put it this way? Sorry, darling. Let me just.
Well, he's
this.
One of those people that looks at it like it's not illegal, therefore it's good. It's like, what?
No, I see.
It's a matter of ethics.
I see it in this one way, which is if you are very strongly defined towards a point. Want to make this point clear and you stand very strong behind this point, you don't be a little pussy and bitch out of a fucking DM or a stream. That just tells me you're a fucking little bitch.
I'm not,
that's all I can say.
I'm not making a pun here.
He's definitely making
a pun. No, I'm not making a pun here because when Jason Lean did the video on him, I actually went and looked up Angry MGTOW's channel and I saw this, like what we're doing right now. He did this stream with this girl and she killed him. And it's like halfway through, I'm like, please stop this man because she is everything you're saying. Yeah. I think he's just an angry, lonely little man.
Who has sex with fuckers? But then his women.
You need a hug?
Yeah, I think he needs a couple of hugs.
I always need
get
a hug.
Get him back here. I'll give him a hug.
Should we all fly to his house and give him a hug?
Yeah.
Or we should dox him and get lots of people to hug him.
No, don't say that because somebody will go, okay.
We should dox him and we get a big hug thing. Everyone just hugs him. It's like, hey, man, life's okay. Women ain't so bad.
The guys can go and hug him, but the women stay away because he might just stab you in the back.
I think he'd cry if a woman hugged him.
I think he
ran out of hooker money, and that's why he's gone off the handle again. Because when he got those hookers, he was great for a while. Like he mellowed right the fuck out, and then I think he just didn't have the hooker money. But maybe we can blame the demonetization. He's not making enough money through ad revenue to get hookers anymore.
Get Angry MGTOW his hookers back.
Yeah, hashtag
the fuck down.
We'll make an Instagram group hashtag Angry MGTOW hookers. Get them back.
But you really
Patreon.
Need
to mellow out. Yeah, we'll get a Patreon. We'll get a hashtag going on Twitter.
It doesn't even need expensive hookers. As long as they got a warm, moist hole.
Yeah. You know what I mean? It don't matter if she's 80 years old. As long as he's getting those hugs.
Just so you know, Dominatrix, Turnip, and Polymer.
Wait, who's Dominatrix? Could everyone else please leave the chat?
Yeah, get the fuck out.
All right, guys, I feel like I'm invading the chat.
No, holy. Not.
Fuck off.
Fuck, did we really start streaming 3 hours ago?
Apparently we did.
Yep.
Wow, I missed a lot.
Damn. I missed a lot. I walked in there.
Man, I need a cigarette. When the hell is this going to end? And I looked down and it's like started streaming 3 hours ago. Well, fuck me.
And Roy said they were only going to be available for like an hour or so.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. Well, usually streams, you know, 1 to 2 hours.
We're not very good at timelines.
No, apparently
I'm
not.
Just so sad. I really wanted to speak to Angry Mikta.
Oh my gosh, you would have destroyed him.
I really wanted to speak to him as troll.
Bring him back.
Oh, God,
Angry Mikta, we miss you, and I want to give you a hug.
I'm going to find this trailer tonight.
If you need that cunt back, you're going to have to make your own streams. couldn't be asked, really.
I might just message him privately.
Just go to my channel. I'm sure my fans would love it.
I'm sure they would. I've suddenly got 5 times as many viewers as I've ever had.
That's what happened.
Oh, I shot right up there. Well over 20 something. And I was just like, wow, that's what we had to do to get viewers?
More drama.
Like, Simon, seriously, Miss Anonymous, Igal, yes. And Creamy, this is my little brother Dominic. Just to do actual formal.
You did.
I might just message Angry MGTOW tonight, be like, hey man, I also hate women. Let's talk about some stuff.
Unless he's listening right now, going, fuck that guy. I'm not gonna be friends with that guy. Fuck him. I don't want his fucking hugs.
He's missing out. They're wonderful hugs. I'm telling you. I've had them. Great.
He's one of them black bears. They're not all the polar bear kind of hugs. Not the ones you really want. If you know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
Oh, yeah.
I do not know what you mean, to be honest with you. Oh, his picture is a polar bear.
Have you seen how sexy that guy actually looks?
He has a very nice jawline, yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's a good chance he's seen the real me, but not the fictional me.
Yeah. MacGyver, to be honest.
MacGyver?
Oh, he wouldn't take MacGyver.
Not MacGyver, you goon. Not your spoon, you mucky.
Well, you're kind of cutting out a bit there.
I like how this has come from a man that hates women to, like, what do you all find attractive in a man? A good jawline. And MacGyver's quite a good-looking one.
Okay. I feel bad because Roy's just sat here, not being able to do anything, so I'm going to pass the headphone to him. That means I won't be able to talk, but hopefully he'll inject all of your minds with some wonderful, juicy, brainless, retarded comments.
Now I'm going back to his stuff.
It's not our minds he should be injecting.
We're going back to gay stuff, guys. Has everyone seen the Force Awakens?
Back to the pile, guys.
Everyone sees Force Awakens, right?
Yes.
Poe Dameron, is he not the most beautiful man alive?
See him approaching.
I want to be him. I want his jacket. I want his hair.
No, he just wants him inside of him, really.
Poe, I just want to be as cool as him. I just want to fly a cool plane. Yeah,
and you love Han Solo's decorations.
Yeah, because Han Solo is also a very cool man. He has nice jackets.
And each time you talk about them, they're just such a beautiful man with such beautiful jawline.
So what we're getting for this, everybody, is that Liam's brother really appreciates a nice jacket.
A nice jacket, a good jawline. Not a leather fetish, just a nice jacket, a nice jawline.
Sorry, I get myself confused with people all the time.
But do you like leather jackets, though?
I'm pretty sure Angry MGTOW has no chin. I don't think he even has a jaw.
I think he's the atheist gamer.
On the neck. He probably doesn't even have a nice jacket. It's probably like a...
Well, no, he had to bring it to the pawn shop for hooker money.
No, seriously, I'm gonna don my tinfoil hat because I honestly think he's the atheist gamer. I think they're the same fucking person.
You know what? I've heard there's three or four of them that all sound really, really similar, and I wonder if it's like maybe they all have the same disability or something.
He's like, feel like
it's called Markov.
Markov O'Connor and well, he's not like the Red Pill Ghost, but him, Atheist Gamer, and like the Angry MGTOW, they all have that same like that nasally teenage tone, but they're all apparently in their like 30s or close to 30.
Yeah,
I bet. What the hell?
I bet he wears like a. Let me say my one last joke. I'll go.
Go.
Go on.
I feel like Angry MGTOW. I bet he wears like a hoodie. With like game the phones on, and everyone's like, "What? Why are you wearing that, man?" I feel like if he was in the jacket shop, he'd end up looking at t-shirts. I don't think he gets jackets. I don't think he gets women. I don't think he gets jackets.
Of course, he doesn't get women. That's why he's so angry.
Yeah. I'm not angry. He doesn't like women. I'm just angry. He doesn't like jackets.
So he's angry because he doesn't like women.
A jacket makes a man, you know what I mean? I bet.
Does it?
Well, you know, not getting laid will piss people off, and it does build up tensions and make you quite stressed out, you know?
And having a nice jacket will get you laid.
It will
do. Just, you know, buy some Tanga eggs, and everything will be fine.
It will do. It's like when you're in school, and that new kid comes with a really cool jacket, and everyone's like, who's that new kid? Where'd he get that jacket from?
Look at that, the way. Let's beat the fuck out of him and take it. That was Angry MGTOW in school.
Oh no, he was the one who got punched and they stole his jacket.
Quick question though, what are Tanga eggs?
Oh yeah,
this is wrong.
Guys, oh, they're
found the mystery.
Your anus, my found friend.
He bought his best jacket. He went to school. A group of girls beat him up and stole his jacket. And from that day on, he was the most angry at the MGTOWs.
Angry MGTOW was born.
God, I don't know what the fuck we're talking about anymore. What's happening?
He sits in his sad quarter, lamenting his lost jacket.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, he has a big wank and he cries. About his jacket.
All over his jacket.
There's nothing big about his wank sessions.
He can't afford lube, so he has to use the tears.
Those delicious male tears.
Oh, yes. He's so multi-purpose, nutritious, great. Delicious, and great for lube.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Miss Anonymous. I've never talked to you before, and this is
either.
The first.
I believe this is the first time we've met.
It is.
Yeah, this is the first time I've ever talked to you. Extremely drunk in a room with three other guys, and I don't know what's happening anymore.
I came in the stream, and he got so triggered, he almost left. And I had to stay quiet the whole time. It was very sad.
No. Yeah, I went for a toilet and I had a cigarette and now I've come back and we're all talking about jacket envy or something.
Well, that's what created him.
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, this is what I do. I come into a very serious debate
and ruin it.
Hey guys, you're like
a good jacket.
I would hardly call what was going on here a serious debate. I mean,
like, the funny thing is, I find that Dominic is very much into Hawaiian light shirts and he's very much into being masculine. And there's a polar bear here in a Hawaiian shirt and he hasn't challenged him for a second.
Oh, this is weird.
Like fucking 15k, bro.
What?
I'm
completely secure in my masculinity and the size of my genitals.
I'm gay.
The challenge.
We saw the video of that. We saw the video. We know.
Hey, that was science, sir. I stick my science very seriously.
Very.
It's not gay if it's for science.
That's right. Unless it's gay science, in which case it's the straightest thing you could do.
That's right.
Nothing more hetero than gay science.
I just want Amy MGTOW to come back.
Me too. We all miss him.
You just like to come on.
I have so many hugs to give.
All the hugs. He just needs a good hug. He needs a good hug.
He really does.
Give all the hugs, none of the fucks.
No. Everyone says he needs a hug. I think he more needs a bitch slap. personally.
Maybe both.
No.
All of the above.
That's what happened when he stole his jacket. He's getting all the
he needs to be bitch slapped, then hugged, then laid.
Yeah.
In that order.
No, I think he needs a good hug.
At the same time.
A nice slap and then a good lay.
No, I think he's going to start crying once he gets slapped, which he'll really need the hug for. And once he's calmed down,
he'll cry more when he gets a hug.
I think he's
never shown that man affection.
I think he'd cry when the girl says hello, to be honest.
Is that why he got so
triggered? I think he's going to cry when the girl, you know, starts laughing when he takes it out and sees how small it is.
Oh, he's jacket.
Hey, men have vaginas.
Right, some lads, men I need have to go. Yes,
some men
I'm gonna make that. I guarantee it. Small penis, shit jacket, got bullied by girls. That's why I hate.
Just a royal. That's Angry MGTOW in a nutshell.
That's his origin story. It's Angry MGTOW's origin. So we're gonna leave now. We're gonna leave now. I've been Lacey. This has been.
Oh, Lacey.
Dominic Flash Troll. The ultimate troll, and
yeah, I'm being forced to leave now, everybody. I would have stayed.
And that's all he had to say. So, it's been a pleasure. There was like some more guys at some point. It's been wonderful. I hope you all have a wonderful evening.
Well, thank you very much
for joining me. I'm trying to say more, but my brother's taking my microphone off me.
Oh, dear.
Saying my goodbye, guys. We're gonna start the movement tonight. Hashtag I'm gonna make Tao. Hashtag get him a hug. Hashtag jacket. Hashtag get him a nice jacket. The best jacket.
It was okay. Nice to meet you, Dominic. Thank you for coming.
Goodbye.
Bye. Oh, nice to
meet you. Yeah, I'm very sorry if you cannot tell. Everyone here is fairly drunk. So I apologize.
That's the best way to
keep doing that. It's so clear we're being so sober.
That is the best way to stream. The drunker you are, the more fun it is.
And the less clothes you have.
I streamed naked sober.
You know, there you go. Like, can I talk to you guys about like one thing before I leave?
What's
yes,
that?
You can.
Like, been something that's like bothering me for a while.
Uh oh.
Do you mind?
Go ahead.
It was, I don't know, it's kind of like, I know it's really dumb. I know it's really hard to actually... It's actually quite hard to talk about, but if you wouldn't mind just giving me 5 minutes of your time.
You can have all the time you like.
Of course.
And my story is goodbye!
Oh, fucker! Liam? Liam? fucking Liam?
There is no Liam.
There's only Zool.
Zool? Zool? I love you, man. You're alright.
Yeah, there he goes.
Yeah. Fuck. Now, I may have to end the stream presently. It's currently 10 to 5 in the morning.
Oh, good lord.
Oh, I know. I'm like, fuck, and I have to get up in a few hours. I'm supposed to go to some thing. Damn it.
Oh, shit. Oh, thankfully, I don't have to get up early in the morning, but...
No, oh, shit, we're in the same time zone. I just realized that.
Yeah, we are. So
we are.
I'm not. It's like 8 p.m. I'm good. I'm good for a while.
It's 5 a.m., so it's
my time zone is the correct time zone.
Well, mine usually was, but I'm in the wrong part of the world right now.
Oh, that's terrible.
Kind of fucking me up for streams because everybody's like, hey, you want to come on the stream at this time? And it's like, that's 5 a.m., you fucker.
That's a perfect time to get drunk and stream. Is
if you don't have work in the morning, yeah.
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt.
Graveyards make everything possible.
I was actually planning on going to bed before Roy tweeted out that they wanted to stream, and I thought, well, fuck, I've been wanting to do have a hangout with Roy and Lacey for a while, And so I jumped on it. And I mean, it's been good fun. And I've been wanting to talk to a girl for a while as well, because he's like fucking awesome.
Yeah, and then I'm just here because reasons.
Enjoy it because reasons, but I've seen you around quite a bit here and there anon, and I think you're quite sexy indeed.
It was really don't embarrass me while we're still live.
What? We're still alive? What? Yeah. No, so it was good to have you on, even though I guess you didn't really get to talk much since
It was worth it just to trigger him by showing up.
Well, that was a brilliant moment.
That was thoroughly awesome amusing.
You're gonna spoil everything.
I did.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Cinders. I love you.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Yeah. So, no.
Find me on the Twitters.
Very much. Sorry?
Find me on. Oh, I'm talking to Mr. Anonymous. Find me on the Twitters. I'm too lazy to look for you right now.
I see you.
What? Where?
On the Twitters.
The Twitters.
Twitters.
It's where everything happens.
It's where only the good things happen.
Twitter. Especially intelligence.
Exactly. Which is why I use it so much.
Oh, ditto.
Mm-hmm. To those still left in the chat, if you haven't subbed to me, please do it. If you haven't subbed to Egal or Little Miss Anonymous here, please do so. Same with very nearly by roll. They're awesome cunts. And please follow me on Twitter and have a nice day. Any shilling you'd like to do before close the
broadcast? No, I'm good, thanks. Have a great night, everybody.
Good night.
All right. Have a good one. Seeps out.